Yeah, we're gonna be getting the corned beef and cabbage out pretty soon. Calm down. We just opened up. Yeah, we got a lot of live music today. We'll have some Irish step dancing. We're going to get the Pipers here. I tell you, it's going to be a blast today. Once again, this is Denny O. Falcone. Happy St. Patrick's Day on the Opie and Anthony program. Oh, they're here. All right, ladies and gentlemen, let's take you back in time as we open up the pot of solid gold with the Irish Rovers.
A long time ago.
Seriously.
I love it.
Seriously.
I'm clenching my jaws.
You just bit your own teeth.
Denny Falcone.
One of the best descriptions ever. Jim Norton saying, I bit my own teeth. You said that years ago. Great. I never forgot it.
Everybody sing!
Yeah.
Why would you open with these guys?
Rats and cats and elephants.
Denny, your opening was a bust.
Yeah,
everything was too loud.
Well,
loud. St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah. No, I had to turn everything down. I had to turn down your. I had to turn down your fake bar.
Fake bar.
No. We're here with Denny O's.
What happened to the crowd if we're at Denny O's? The crowd's back.
You want me to mic the crowd? We'll mic the crowd. Let me get the sound guy on.
Denny O. Falcone.
Good morning.
How you doing? Happy St. Patty's Day, everyone.
This seemed like a good idea on paper.
I love it.
Denny's spinning the tunes today for St. Patrick's Day.
It's so festive.
It's a really festive bar for this early.
Yeah.
Sure is. Wow.
Very respectful and quiet, though. Whenever we talk, they pipe right down.
It's true. It's nice. Nice of them.
Can I get a cold one, Denny? You got that sound effect?
We'll get some cold ones for you, sure.
You don't have that sound effect for the cold ones?
I think Tim said we're not allowed to drink in the studio, so I want to kind of keep things on the down low today.
Oh, is that it?
I like this much better when Jerry Mortier used to do it.
Jerry's gin joint.
We got the cheap version of Jerry's gin joints.
What would he do, that fake, like, audience?
It was
in the
amazing.
Back?
I can't even make fun of it. People were convinced that Jerry was broadcasting from a bar every Friday or whatever, or every other.
He did a good job.
He did an amazing job with it.
Yeah.
We would get phone calls at the radio station. Where is this place? It sounds amazing. All right, Denny, so you'll be here all morning, right?
Sure.
All right.
Yay.
Very nice.
Today, boy, I tell you.
For this St. Patty's Day, don't you know?
Who can afford to, like, take off to hang out at a parade all day?
What are you talking about?
Like, everybody that goes to the St. Patty's Day parade. Most of these parades are on, like, a Sunday or some shit like that.
Right.
Like, it's Monday, and people just take off of work to get drunk at...
Yeah.
At the parade?
Yeah.
Fucking weird.
Some Humpty Bat camels and some ding dong ding. Some cats and rats and elephants, we're sure as you're born. You're never going to see no unicorn.
Dun dun. Yeah.
All right.
That's it. Kicking off our St. Patty's Day extravaganza.
Here in Denny O. Falcone.
Denny O. Falcone.
I know we're live
at hits.
Denny O. Falcone.
Do you want to be live all morning?
Well, let me see.
We're going to have a jig contest in a little while, too.
A what contest?
A jig. An Irish jig contest.
Oh, jig.
How about that?
Oh.
I'm looking at the winner right now.
Yeah. Hey, don't you know?
Let's hear it with the crowd and without the crowd.
Crowd really brings it alive.
It certainly does. Denny O. Falcone. Holy shit.
Yes, they do.
I love it.
I've got some festive beats for everyone also.
Oh, look at that. Festive beats.
Anal beats.
That's leftover Mardi Gras stuff.
No, it's green. You see, there's green ones in here, too.
Okay.
It's leftover from Mardi Gras. You have one green.
Oh, I have some more here.
Oh. And he's got...
And I've got a cap. I've got a nice Irish derby here.
A leprechaun hat kind of a thing.
You've just
got to believe in the fun of it. That's all. You just have to believe. Because
we need midgets
this,
like
this
in
the magic
Boardwalk
of radio.
Empire. The little midgets.
All right, well. Hey. Just amazing stuff. Thanks, Daddy.
Yeah,
you got any of that kick ass?
You're like,
oh, yeah, I can get that on for you.
That's what we want.
Oh, you want that too?
What is it? Golden hard drive of hits? What is it?
The solid gold. The solid pot of gold.
Pot of gold.
Oh, he said that?
I think
yeah,
he did.
Yeah, I said that.
I wasn't listening.
Oh, please.
I wasn't listening to that part. Give us something upbeat.
Oh, you want something upbeat, too? Okay, let's see what we can do for you here today.
Yeah.
Or do you want Sam to play it?
For the big...
Dicey Riley by the Dubliners.
Yes. Oh. This is Ronnie Drew.
That's Dubliners.
This isn't what... I didn't ask for this.
This is tradition. This is tradition.
Sam, if you will, please. Up there, Dicey Riley. This is what I wanted.
This is the only rocking song.
It's kind of a little tradition, you know?
Yeah. Oh, this is tradition here.
I'm dipping into the...
I'm shipping up to Boston. Dropkick Murphys! All right! Janet! Janet! Stuff like this, Denny.
Okay.
Every movie now where there's an Irish mob, they gotta play this song.
There's more than one guy wearing green in a scene. They gotta play this.
It's all right, though. I'm still not sick of this song.
The big montage scene of them driving somewhere to pull a job.
Where Forrest Whitaker walks out. This is a good walkout song for Forrest Whitaker. This is his walkout.
Oh,
it was, yeah.
Look at the guys hugging in the video. Like, hey. Fuck yeah.
I bet they drink. Janet.
You think they're booked today?
Oh, boy, are they.
Yeah.
Where are they booked today? It's got to be in Boston, right?
Yeah.
There was a long time where they weren't allowed to play in Boston.
Oh, really?
So, on St. Patrick's Day, yeah.
Why?
Because it was just too rowdy.
Too crazy?
This was back like 15 years ago. I saw them in New Jersey on St. Patrick's Day because they couldn't play in Boston because it was just too... crazy.
Wow.
Yeah.
People go see them?
Oh, they're in Boston today.
I mean, 15 years ago when they were like more of a punk hardcore band than they were a mainstream band that they are now, it was insane.
Sold out, huh? In Boston.
Sold out in Boston today. Dropkick Murphys.
Where are they playing?
Lansdowne Pub.
Damn. I bet there'll be a lot of drinking going on there. Oh, yeah.
What's that? What's that?
Oh, yeah. I bet they play it for longer than that live. I bet that song goes on for 15 fucking minutes.
Oh, I'm sure.
When they do it live.
We're back here at the bar. Welcome
to
Denny O's. I know it's getting kind of crowded in here.
Yeah, let me get through here, Denny. I need to get me a Guinness.
Little table for two right there in the back for you. Oh, look who's here. It's the Corrigan Brothers. Yeah, we've got the Corrigan Brothers here for you today. And we're having ourselves a great time today. Happy St. Patrick's Day. And a great Irish tune from the Corrigan Brothers for you.
What the hell's going on?
Apparently it's St. Patty's Day.
Oh, all right. You're getting requests on the phones there, Denny.
Wow.
Denny old Falcone.
Who are the Sioux Eyesides?
Charlie. Or is it Charlie? It is Philly, so it could be Charlie. Charlie.
Good morning, fellas. How you doing?
Good. What's up, buddy?
Hey, I'd like to make a request to the Dennis O. Falcone, Vlado Doodle, St. Patrick's Day show.
Okay. Yeah. What do you got?
Flogging Molly, Devil's Dance Floor. Thank you very much.
Do you have that one at least?
We got some Flogging Mollies for you, too.
All right. Oh. All right, good. Maybe you can work that in.
Everyone's Irish today, right?
Yes.
Isn't that it?
Everybody's Irish on St.
Like
Patrick's Day.
Like the tie? Shamrock tie he's wearing there. Very festive.
It's already all over the phones. Can we address something?
Oh, right.
I learned over the weekend because only maybe 2,000 people.
That's it, huh?
Passed along the info that Mayor Menino is in the last stages of his life, basically.
Poor Mayor Menino.
Yeah.
He's got the big casino.
Right. And people want us to comment about it.
They should have went to Dr. Kennedy.
Obviously, it's horrible news for him and his family. What do you want from us?
Yeah, what are we supposed to do?
I'm not happy about it.
Celebrate?
Well, if you read some of these tweets, I think that's what they were looking for.
Crazy.
And they don't even know where it's based out of. Like, it's one of those 2 or 3% cancers where they don't know.
Right.
It metastasized. They don't know exactly the source of it. Because it wasn't there last year.
He's got late stage. He's in late stage cancer, or what? How the hell would you say?
I want to say stage 3, but they're saying that, yeah.
Calling it good luck, bro.
Yeah. Wow. It's horrible news. Of course, it's horrible news for him and his family, especially. It's a bit we did so many years ago.
Yeah, wow.
That, honestly, as an older gentleman, I'm not even happy we ever did that.
But what are you going to do? The jig?
Right.
It's crazy.
What are you going to do? We did it back in the day, but. I'm not touching that one. That's just horrible news. Late stage cancer, though.
That is an interesting concept there. How ironic would it be if Mayor Menino actually did die on April 1st of this year?
That would be extremely creepy.
Quite the creepy thing, wouldn't
it? So, advanced form of cancer. And then Fred Phelps also has the big casino.
Oh.
Fred Phelps.
Really?
His family's keeping they're not talking about it. They're not letting any estranged members visit.
Right.
His son, who left the church in 76, Nate Phelps, posted it on his Facebook. That's how people know about it. He's in the hospice. Good. That's what I'm happy about. Good.
Wow.
I hope it hurts. I hope it really hurts.
Damn.
One of the papers went all in with that, too.
Yeah.
Did you see that, the headline?
I didn't, no.
Hold on a minute.
Oh, was it one of those funny, catchy...
This is the Daily News. They write today, guy whose church spews hate at soldiers' funerals is on his deathbed, and the headline is, here's hoping he suffers.
Wow, there it is.
That's pretty brave right there of the Daily News.
Yes.
Wow. So,
damn.
Yeah, he's a real piece of garbage.
Damn.
Jimmy referenced Forrest Griffin, but called him Forrest Whitaker.
Oh, that's
why. Oh, did I call him Forrest Whitaker? Oh. I meant Forrest Griffin. Forrest Whitaker does not fight in the UFC.
No.
And if he did, he would not walk out to a dropkick Murphy song.
No. That was a
thank
weird
you, sir.
Image I had in my head.
I said that, right? I didn't mean to.
Yeah.
I'm sleepy. I'm cute.
Whatever.
Cute and sleepy.
So we got Dennis spinning the tunes for St. Patrick's Day.
Uh-huh.
And then we got...
A lot of people wondering if this even went down today.
Well, we got a new intern today.
We have a brand new intern.
I heard she's already been a major pain in the ass. I've also heard that she was singing along to all the Irish songs in the other room.
Of course.
I also heard that she stinks to high heaven.
Cigarettes?
That's right.
Of cigarettes. Denny. What happened there?
With the crowd loop.
Oh, you want the crowd back all morning? You want them? Okay.
We're here in the bar, right? We're giving the illusion that maybe we are broadcasting live.
Okay, fine.
Denny O.
I knew you were talking about a little something somber there.
Denny O. Yes.
You waited until they were done and then.
Yeah, but the crowd wouldn't know. Half of them wouldn't hear the broadcast. They don't care. So what do you got on Lady Di as the intern today, Sam?
She is here.
Give me all the details. What time did she arrive? All that shit.
Well, we had our other intern pick her up.
Oh, right. I did hear that on the way home last week.
Our intern, Adrian, had to drive her in. And he said that she did confess to him that she was a little nervous. So about 1:30, 2 o'clock in the morning, she did help herself to a beverage or two.
Oh,
wait, she's been up since 1?
That's what she said, yeah.
And
she's been nervous.
She's a little nervous.
She's probably got some real stinky gassers because she's nervous.
Oh, right.
She came in. She did stink. Roland has already moved all of her stuff out of his office and next to Dennis Falcone's desk.
Oh, Dennis O. Falcone, by the way.
Right.
So Dennis O. Falcone will have an office mate for the week.
We all got the O names today.
Yes.
Although mine doesn't work as well.
I thought the last name.
How about Gregory O'Hughes? But Gregory O'Hughes. Gregory. G-R-E-G-G apostrophe R-Y.
Right.
Gregory O'Hughes.
Gregory O'Hughes. Jimmy O'Norton.
What?
Jimmy O'Norton.
See, that works. A good one.
Jimmy O'Norton, it does.
Yeah.
Jimmy O'Norton over there.
Jimmy O'Norton.
What's he doing?
The Okumia doesn't work at all.
No.
Can't take that Dago name and make it Irish.
Yeah.
No. And she's very flirtatious, too.
Oh, yeah. God.
Why? With like, who?
Of all the interns to be flirtatious.
Exactly. I would rather have every other intern, including David, be flirtatious.
Creepy Jones.
She came in and wrapped her arm around me and tried to kiss me on the cheek.
Did you let her?
No.
Why?
You should go to human resources.
I told her this is becoming a major HR issue.
Come on.
Human resources issue.
Yes. So she wouldn't qualify.
Yes, do we have monster resources here?
She's also blowing kisses.
Oh, boy.
Who's he? Yeah. Some guy who should cut his dick off and throw it.
She did go with the interns on the food runs this morning.
Okay, cool.
All right, good.
So she got the coffee.
She looks lovely.
Waving.
She's dress not, up.
Look. Iraq.
Keep her close because we're going to get her on the air.
She's not.
What?
She's about to do a run.
She's right. A food run. She's an intern.
Let her do a run, yeah.
But let her know she's not to distract the talent like that. If an intern walked by and started waving to
Dude,
us,
she can do whatever she wants.
You think waving is bad?
Yeah.
I was doing the pre-show in close quarters in there.
Yes.
And she starts tapping me on the shoulder while I'm talking. And then she's coughing. I go, okay, just shut up. And she goes, okay. 5 seconds of silence, and then...
Oh, that fucking morning smoker hack she's got.
Well, the poor dear. You know, she's coming in here working hard. We didn't think she'd show up, but she shows up, and she's sick.
That's right.
That's
she
true.
Goes, sorry, I smoke.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah, really.
She'll smoke it out. Oh. She'll suck down a ciggy on the way out.
Oh, yeah. She'll be outside making a run and... Good opportunity to suck down a ciggy.
E-Rock, you got anything on our new intern?
Well,
I need some observations.
She's been productive, I'll say that.
Doing what?
She helped set up the studio. She got the newspapers.
What did she touch?
Everything. She got coffee this morning.
She's been screening calls. The last several calls that have been screened were screened through Lady Di.
How are ya?
Good morning, Opie and Anthony.
And then she would, while the show was on live, she left her ringer on, and I said, turn your phone off. And she goes, well, then call Marion. No, what are you talking about? Call Marion.
Why?
Why would we talk to Marion?
I guess Marion was the one that was calling.
It took a photo. I'm going to put it up on O&A show on Twitter.
Yeah.
Her throwing a fit because she doesn't know how to put someone on hold.
It's not throwing
so
a fit.
So she's screaming at the other intern, how do I do this? Oh, see?
Hi, Jimmy.
Hi, Dice.
Hi, Dice. She's opening the door so Kenny can deliver the food.
That's nice. She's helping.
Yeah.
There you go.
All dressed up. Go down, have a ciggy, and come back up.
You think she helped herself to a ciggy?
Really yeah. Dressed up, but okay if you say so.
Well, delightful.
Well, we told you to dress up. You look nice.
A little bit.
You look okay.
I don't have any makeup on though.
Really?
Oh wow!
You tell?
I couldn't even tell.
She's ignoring you so she can get back to work.
Yeah, she doesn't want to futz around in here. She wants to get busy out there. No makeup. I didn't even notice.
I thought she had makeup on from The Walking Dead.
No, she looks like that weird mask in Saw Part 3. That weird puppet thing that sat there.
Yeah. No, she does. The fucking little fucking puppet thing.
Yeah.
The mask that comes on the TV screens and stuff.
That's a new one. That's really good.
Oh, God. Her face is so weird.
While you were talking to Danny O'Falcone, Travis was in my headphones because she was in the little studio with Travis.
Oh. Uh-huh.
Going, we're 5 minutes in and she's driving me fucking crazy.
Yeah, but Travis has to know he's married and he can't start flirting around. And
that's true.
You got to just take it and deal with it. We all have women we want to sleep with.
Where'd she just wander off to?
She's off to do a Starbucks run.
Is she getting my oatmeal?
Oh,
Jesus.
I'll have a cappuccino, too.
God. She's getting that as well.
With Slender Milk.
I could use a coffee, too.
Getting some oatmeal to refill her tits.
Yes, please.
Just give Lady Di a call and let her know what the update is.
You don't like them?
No. They're terrible. Her boobs.
Is she going to show her boobs?
Her bubs.
Her bubs or boobs.
Well, she's not wearing a bra today.
No. Oh, she's all. Her breasts do look like two socks filled with fucking blood sausage.
Fuck, that's bad.
Oh, wow.
She talked to Travis about what she was doing in there.
Yeah, Travis.
What was she doing in there?
Well, it's a tiny booth where Travis sits. Yeah. And she was in there with him.
It fits right in.
And it reeks of cigarette smoke in there now.
Already.
Yeah.
And she wasn't smoking in there.
No.
She just carries the aroma with
her. That's like secondhand smoke that comes off her body.
Yeah. Well, you know, she sucks one down and hops right in that elevator.
She loves it.
And then wafting through her hair.
And she's got the stale beer breath.
Do we have beer here for her?
No,
I'm sure she. I'm sure she took care of herself with something.
All right, I hope she sneaks a couple in her big jacket.
And it's just inane question after inane question.
Yeah,
yeah.
Can they see me? Where's the camera? Can they see me? Where's Opie?
Yeah,
where's
Jim? And then while the show's on live, the pre-show is on live, the mic's live.
Right.
She's just standing right behind me and goes, oh, look who it is. It's Opie and Anthony. She's looking through the window.
Doesn't she know you're on the air and you're not supposed to?
Of course. Like, why wouldn't you be here?
That dumb jacket she's wearing. She's dressed like Linderman from My Bodyguard.
She's standing behind my chair, like pulling down on it as she's watching you guys.
Bravo.
Holy fuck. She really is by far the most cumbersome intern that we've ever had.
Yes.
Well, it's her first day. Give her a little break.
Give her some time to adjust.
You're right.
Usually the first day, the intern's like kind of just hanging back a little bit. Soaking it all in.
And of course, we got to get to know our intern like we do all the other interns.
Oh, yes.
Yeah.
Of course.
The time-honored tradition.
Yes, it sure is.
The sexy young one we haven't spoken to once on air, but fuck she's already, this one's already.
Yeah, she's the one we'll give the big interview to.
Yeah.
All right, we got food. We got Lady Di did show up for her internship for a week.
Yeah. You got food, Denny, and a monster.
And,
and what?
Did you read a certain somebody's tweets at Bobo?
Not really. I blocked him a while ago.
Good.
Uh-oh.
Bobo tweeted out that he doesn't want to be on the show or anything, but he just wants to make sure everybody knows that he'll be right outside the building early to get a good spot for the parade if anybody wants to call him.
Is he already out there?
I don't know. We can go check, though.
He probably is.
We might have to check on Bobo to see if he's the first person to arrive for the parade.
He would be a good roving reporter today.
Yes.
Yeah, we might have to go to him.
Not a bad idea, Sam Roberts. What bar are we in?
We're at Denny O's today.
Of course.
Oh, look, we've got the green bagels arriving. Very good. Put those over here. We'll get some green bacon as well for you.
Wait.
He's actually acting.
Yeah.
I love it.
No.
He's pantomiming.
We got the green eggs and ham. Yeah, okay, very good.
Denny.
Once again, happy St. Patrick's Day. Yeah, hold on.
No one walked in with bagels.
Theater of the mind, my friend. Theater of the mind.
Exactly.
Radio.
I like to watch a bullet tear right through your theater.
All right, keep going, Denny.
Lots of Irish favorites for you today, both old and new, as we dip into the pot of solid gold. But I know one of our co-hosts this morning just happens to love a good song by The Pogues.
Oh.
So let's crank this one up for you. Turn it up by The Pogues. Happy St. Paddy's Day. Happy St. Paddy's Day to Anthony Okubia and Opie O'Opie and Jimmy O'Norton. Everybody is here today. And Sammy O'Roberts, the whole crew. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Opie and Anthony have been creating broadcasting magic for 20 years. Dug from the O&A vaults, this is a 20th anniversary O&A radio gem.
What's the cinnamon challenge?
You got to give it to him if he really needs it. We can't have this idiot.
Take a teaspoon.
It's supposed to be a tablespoon.
Just give him a teaspoon. Right. Let's see what this does.
We're not going to use the little sprinkle. That will take 9 days to get it on the
front. 9 days.
Ready? One, two, three, go.
Okay.
Fuck it up.
E-Rock is attempting.
All right, E-Rock.
Smoke is coming out of him.
He's smoking.
What is
it? All right, E-Rock.
He's like that old wrestler.
Water, you asshole.
Holy shit, a whole cloud came out. Drink a little water. Inhale. Breathe water. Slow.
Water, 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 water.
Breathe slow.
Through your nose, fuckface.
You all right?
He's cute.
Jesus.
Breathe water. Drink water.
This is the most horrible thing I've ever seen.
You gotta drink water.
Drink water.
Drink water.
Drink a little water.
Something just came out of his forehead.
You okay?
Water just came out of his forehead.
E-Rock.
Water.
It smells so nice in here, though.
It does.
It smells like cinnamon toast. It
smells like Christmas.
The cloud of cinnamon that went across the
E-Rock.
Give us a thumbs up if you're all right.
Shut up.
Oh, holy shit. E-Rock, we just want to make sure you're okay.
You can't breathe.
He's all right. He's just...
Just slowly, very slowly.
You gotta
slowly.
Do it.
It's like mustard gas. Take a little bit of water, just a little in your mouth.
Oh.
A little in your mouth.
Little sip.
Like, someone get him a napkin.
Are you puking?
We'll just gargle and spit the water out.
Yeah,
man.
Gargle and spit the water
very
out.
Very slow breaths.
You have to breathe like you're giving birth. Like that.
Holy shit. Dude, that was fucking bad. All right. Just breathe.
Wow, just breathe. Man. What the fuck is that stuff? I never heard of that.
What does that do?
I can't. Do you want to do it again?
What's the matter?
Let him.
Wow.
God,
shut up.
Nasty, man.
That is bad. You're right, E-Rock?
What a weird reaction that is, though. I would never have fucking...
See, even the water. He can't drink water down, because, right? Because the cinnamon keeps going down.
But you know what? This is the weird thing, is that this cures cancer if you do this once.
Shut
you'll always,
up!
No, seriously. You'll be immune to cancer.
Shut up! Well, once again, it doesn't work. You can't do that. You can't eat.
Wait, you know
cinnamon.
What? Before we decide, did he really try it?
Shut the fuck up. Yes, he did.
Kids are in the pool.
Now back to the Opal and Anthony
on Sirius XM.
Happy St. Patrick's Day. Welcome back into Denny O's. Good to see you. Glad you can make it down nice and early this morning. Oh, by the way, we're celebrating everything green today. So as we dip into the pot of solid gold down here at Denny O's, let me take you back in time. 48 years ago, when this was number one for five, yes, count them, five big weeks on the pop charts. It's the Ballad of the Green Berets on St. Patrick's Day.
Fighting soldiers from the sky. Fearless men who jump and die.
Everybody stand at attention, please.
Men who mean just what they say.
Raise your glasses to the Green Beret.
Denny, we're not in a bar.
Calm down over there, sir. We'll get you online. Yeah, I know. We only have one men's room. Relax.
Only one men's room.
Oh, I see.
Is it because the beret is green?
Yes.
I don't think this is traditionally a St. Patty's Day song.
No, but it's green. We're celebrating everything green.
Already ran out of St. Patty's songs.
And no. It's a little twist.
A little twist.
You got to think outside the box once in a while.
I gotcha.
Yeah, right. We really should start doing that. Thinking outside the box.
Outside the box. Right, right.
Thank you. Denny O. Falcone.
Denny O. Falcone, Anthony O'Cumia, Opio Opie, Jimmy O. Norton.
It's all down today. Opie.
Celebrating on St. Patrick's Day.
Are we?
Is it men? America's best. License to kill gophers.
All right, well, my food has arrived. I don't know why I didn't get my food with your food.
Oh, boy. Here it comes.
Bring the green bagels in.
Oh. Hi, Lady Di. Wow. Thank you.
The Siggy.
What?
Ode la Siggy.
I said, you have a spoon in there? That's okay.
Okay. Wow. You smell like cigarettes. Like stale cigarettes.
It smells like cigarettes.
Huh?
Stay there. No.
Yeah, did you suck down a Siggy? You have to talk louder. Did you talk? I did it in the mic right there. Did you suck down a Siggy?
No, get away from my mic.
Don't worry, I'm not going to contaminate you with anything.
All right, we get on Mike.
I just don't like Siggy's.
Get on Mike.
I don't like Siggy's. Get on that mic. God damn it.
Our intern is here. It's Lady Di.
Wow, yeah, that's Siggy.
Yeah.
I don't smell like cigarettes. My coat does.
Well, why don't you wash your coat?
Yeah. At the front of a train.
Why don't you give me a look?
Yeah, she looks at you like you're the idiot.
Yeah, you can wash your coat.
Why wouldn't you wash your coat if it smells like Siggy?
I want your bed buggy
like
jacket near mine. Put it over there. You got bed bugs. I love you.
Bed bugs.
Yes, you do. Put it over there. Your bed buggy.
Don't put it on a chair.
What am I going to put on the floor?
We have a coat check room here at Denny O's.
No, right, we don't.
Right down the end there. Yeah.
We're in a radio studio.
Yeah, why don't you leave your jacket in the office?
Hello, Colleen.
No, pick up your jacket. Put your jacket in.
Because I might have to run some more errands. Did you ever think about that?
No, yeah.
Oh. You're right. She's right.
So I need got jacket.
Lady Di, by the way, yeah, congratulations.
On what? On what? Congratulations on what?
A delightful sweater.
Looks like.
Lady Di, you are positively glowing.
Yes.
Congratulations.
You're glowing, all right.
What are you, about 7 months? Be nice. What are we looking at? A May
seven
baby?
7 months of what?
Are we looking at a May baby or what?
Oh.
We're not looking at any baby at all.
What? Are you with Monster?
No, I'm not with Monster.
Is there a dud in the oven?
You're not pregnant?
No, I'm not pregnant.
Oh.
Any other
Sorry.
Questions?
Awkward. Oh.
What time Sorry did you have to that leave home this morning?
Oh, Julie, you see the wiggle?
I left.
You guys
left
missed the wiggle.
I saw it.
Can you wiggle again?
4:30.
That's how you pull your pants up? You wiggle from side to side?
Yeah.
Do it again.
Okay, like this.
She lifts him up and she, there you go. Good girl.
That's it.
You know, lovely,
oh, by the way, Jimmy, I saw you on Channel 11.
Oh, the WPIX.
Yeah, the show where you were doing some kind of a restaurant thing or something like that.
Yes, it's called the Celebrity Tastemakers.
Celebrity Whoa Tastemakers.
And I went to the Porterhouse nice Steakhouse.
Matter of fact, I called the mayor and she goes, quick, turn on Channel 11. Guess who's on? And I turned around and I said, Jimmy!
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Yeah, this is great. So I was watching that. What was that?
Hey, you can't bring dogs in here. You can't bring the dogs in here.
Gotta go, Di.
It's an Irish setter. It's okay. It's an Irish setter.
What was that lady's name that you
is
were
with? Irish setter
that you were with?
No.
That lady that you were with.
I don't remember.
In the limousine.
Yeah, I know who you mean. She runs the show.
I forgot her name.
Yeah, she's from PIX 11.
Uh-huh.
Lady Di?
The one with the long black hair.
Yeah,
you wanted,
pretty,
you wanted to ask Jim a question about his coffee?
Did I want to? Well, I already got his coffee.
Thank you.
Skim milk?
Slender milk.
You know what she asked in the phone screen room?
Huh.
She said, I wanted to know, why doesn't Jim just get his own coffee?
Oh, no, I did not say that.
Oh,
I did not say
that. She didn't say that. She didn't say it. And they're all saying she did indeed say that.
Well, why did you say that?
I'm sorry, Jimmy, if I said that by accident.
That's okay.
It's a
by accident. She said it by accident. You don't say things by accident.
Sometimes I say things and they don't come out the right way.
That's a fair question, though, the intern asks. And she wants to know why.
But I need to ask all of you something.
Oh, God.
Oh, yes, Lady Di.
Why warm water?
What?
Why do you drink warm water?
You have to
all
stand
the
over there a little bit, just because I've got a space with you.
I like my water room temperature. Why?
Oh, room temperature?
Yeah.
No, because I got the water. I'm like, this is warm. Are you sure they want it like that? I thought maybe you wanted cold water.
That's a good question, too.
Great question.
In all these years, no one else has wondered if we want our water cold.
Right.
So she's doing a great job.
You don't touch all the waters.
God.
But she's doing a little temperature check. I like that.
Yeah. Yeah, huh?
I was just wondering about that. I mean, you know,
how is it getting up early?
I always get up early.
She does.
Not that early.
I get up early. I couldn't even sleep last night.
Why?
Because I was nervous about today.
I got to say, so far you're doing a good job. You look great.
I look great.
The smell is brutal.
But except I look pregnant, right?
Well, the sweater's a little tight.
Yeah,
I'm sorry.
The sweater's going to be.
I really thought you were pregnant, though. I wasn't even going for a joke.
No, I'm not pregnant.
Do you want to hear about it?
I'm 52 years old as of next week. I am not pregnant.
You want to hear about her efficiency?
Yes. April 1st, I'll be 52.
That's your birthday?
Yeah.
April 1st!
After our intern, after our intern Adrian had to drive her in,
right?
He also had to take her out on errands this morning.
Okay,
and she decided that instead of using two spaces in the revolving door, she would be efficient and get in the same area.
I did that.
Why would you do that?
I don't know. I just
efficiency.
She was a little nervous.
Did you get nervous?
I am nervous. Yeah, sure, I'm nervous.
You've been up since one?
I've been up since. I don't know, around maybe 2:30.
What time do you go to bed? Huh? What time did you go to bed?
Well, I went to bed at about 11 o'clock, but then I couldn't sleep.
Okay.
Because you're excited to be in here for a week.
Any discharge?
We know what happens when you get excited.
Yeah.
You come.
When you woke up at 2:30.
Discharge.
When you woke up at 2:30, did you crack open a nice cold natty ice?
Natty?
No, actually, I had two beers at about 2 o'clock in the morning because
that's exactly what
I couldn't sleep.
Wait, what was wrong with what I said? Didn't I ask if you cracked open a natty ice? What?
I cracked open two o'clock. Of them.
Oh,
two.
She's saying no, Opie, I did not crack open a natty ice.
Oh,
I had two
of them.
Okay.
Because I could not sleep.
Ah.
All right.
I gotcha.
What's been your favorite part of the internship so far?
My favorite part is serving you guys.
Oh, boy.
I really like that.
You like that?
Nice to know.
I do.
Why?
Huh?
It's kind of motherly.
Why?
Huh?
It's motherly, right?
It is. I think that's why.
But
what do you think of the callers?
Can we suck your boobs?
What? What'd you say?
Nothing. I didn't say that.
All right.
You're screening calls. What'd you think of the callers?
Oh well, no. I don't care. The callers are fine.
Right.
But the problem is the pushing the buttons and then typing in everything.
That's a problem.
It's been a while since I had a regular computer, so.
Gotcha.
All right.
What about
Family Dollar? Did you go?
Yeah, I went and I applied for a job there. I used the computer. I did everything that they told me to, and all I have to do is wait for a phone call.
Oh, so any day now?
I guess so. I hope so.
No.
I hope so.
Well,
that would be nice.
I think you have to.
You talk about efficiency.
Yeah.
I'm just getting word.
What's that? We got the Pipers. The Pipers will be coming by. All right, good.
Oh.
We got the Pipers coming by today.
I love the pantomime thing. I love that he's literally like looking
Denny,
around, waving at people.
Hold on, Denny.
Yeah. We're going to make some room down on front by the stage.
I'm turning his fake crowd off.
What happened to the crowd? Problem with the microphones?
I think Anthony heard it, too. We could hear the loop.
I love it.
What, you got lazy and only recorded 30 seconds of live crowd?
No, this is a crowd. This is a live crowd.
You can hear where it loops.
Yeah, you can.
It's your hat now.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, it's your hat now.
I just found out. I received note that while Lady Di was getting you guys Starbucks, she also asked for a job application.
I did. Good.
Where? At Starbucks?
At the Starbucks.
While she was.
Oh, what? Did
but
you get it?
You have to apply online. One more time online. See all these jobs.
Well, you have access to computers here. You're an intern.
Well, yeah, but we don't want her applying for a job while she's supposed to be interning. Yeah.
You punch up that resume when you fill it out online?
I don't have a resume.
Yeah, but do you, that's just it. Do you punch it up a little, your experience, where you've been working? Maybe you lie a little bit.
I used to have a resume, but I don't have one anymore.
Oh, yeah?
All right, what does she have to do next?
Next, what's up next on the plate? She's got to get back to screening calls, because she's got to perfect the art of call screening.
All right, cool.
Yeah, but you need a new set of headphones over there, because I could barely hear.
Yeah, we do now.
Hey, Denny.
Yeah. Hold on a second. What's that? We need some more. We need some more plastic beer cups.
Stop all stuttering. Right.
Hold on.
Hold. Why can't you just talk?
It's just conversation. It's off the cuff talking to people.
Oh. Plus the crowd is so loud.
Where were those? Because you always do that one. Getting cups.
The Pipers are here. Hold on, the Pipers are here.
The Pipers are here.
Could you make some room for the Pipers, please?
Is that what they're calling them now? The Canadians?
Here they are. Pipers. Are they?
Hey, Denny, by the way.
Here they come.
Because it doesn't matter. Could we be at, F.H. Riley's today?
Oh,
instead?
Wow.
We could go on location. We could go satellite dropping around the country to different Irish bars. We'll go to F.H. Riley's in Long Island pretty soon. Let's turn our attention to the Pipers.
He's not ready for F.H. Riley's.
No,
aren't you ready for F.H. Riley's? It doesn't matter if it's all fake. Can't we just be at F.H. Riley's now?
I want to make sure the satellite hookup is working.
That's a great character.
No. Wait.
Leave it on.
Yeah.
It's my eyes.
All right, Lady Di.
Right back.
Okay.
Why are you putting your
she's going to put it in there because I think it's better.
Oh, the coat?
Yeah.
Because this is a radio studio, not an intern coat.
Let's hear it for the Pipers. Doing a great job.
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Your jacket is green for St. Patrick's Day. Great.
What does it smell like?
Yeah.
Nothing unfamiliar.
French parents smelled like my whole life, so that doesn't bother me.
Uh-huh.
I hate that smell.
I don't like it, but it's one of those things I'm so used to. And
yeah.
That just reminds me of being around people that are drinking and drugging heavily.
I'm just not used to it anymore. When you smell it, you're like, oh my God, remember? Everyone used to have a coat like that, just that reeked of cigarettes.
I'm making her put it in Travis's office. She used to deal with it.
She's just standing outside staring at me.
Well, she's staring and she wants to stare. Now you know what you need to
now
do?
Now she's walking down there with the coat.
Now she's just wandering down that hallway with the coat.
Look at that walk. Look at the, oh my God, look at her walk.
I think she needs to, let a duty loose.
It looks like she's got to take a dump.
Yeah. She's going from side to side.
She's stiff-legging.
Look, she's holding her coat up like, where do I put this?
Yeah. Roland's down there just pointing away from...
Roland is pointing towards
Denny. He's pointing toward Denny Falcone's area.
Yes.
Roland is so fucking pissed about this whole thing.
Oh, he can't be happy.
Why? He hates Lady Di, and because we always sit... Because Roland's office doubles as the green room, which means that's where Lady Di would go. It's the intern office.
Yeah.
He hates it.
He doesn't like it at all.
He likes his things a certain way.
Now, Iraq's pointing down here, and she's once again struggling to walk down the hall. Look at that disaster of a body.
She's still holding her coat?
No. Holy she shit. Dropped it off at Denny's desk.
What would it take you to fuck that? Anyone? Yeah, I thought so.
I couldn't even fake it. I was going to go with...
Holy
She's
shit.
She's coming back in. I don't know why.
Oh.
What? Huh? You're
supposed to go do the phone. Di, you're an intern. You're not a personality.
Why are you coming back in here?
I thought you wanted me to come back over here. Do the phones? All right. Good. Okay.
Those jeans, too. They're just, it's the whole package.
I love her.
Oh, my God.
I love her.
Wow.
She's still got Dennis's green hat on.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well,
Dennis doesn't want it anymore.
No.
Denny's cheap green hat.
Hey,
how much does that cost you? $1.70?
We got the satellite hookup. We're in F.H. Riley's out on Long Island now. Yeah. Can we come in? All right. We got him. What's that?
Yep. What?
They just got off the ferry and they made their way up to the stage out there at FH. Oh, very good. Let's bring in the dubliners.
Hold on. There's no ferry that drops you off at
FH. Exactly, in the middle of fucking Long Island. Where's the ferry going to go?
Part of that. Just it's all part of that theater of the mind thing. Just, wow, they got a ferry and everything.
I mean, no one's going, wow, they got a ferry and everything.
No, because a lot of people have been to FH Riley's. They know there's no water
ferry.
That close.
People who haven't.
Yes, we never mentioned a ferry.
It's Long Island. It's sort of surrounded by water, so there could be a ferry anyway.
All right, keep going.
We want to bring them up on stage. The dubliners are here.
Oh.
As I was going over the far-famed Kerry Mountains, I met with Captain Farrell and his money he was counting. I first produced me pistol and I then produced me rapier. Say, stand and deliver. You are a bold deceiver, a shering of Lulanda. Why fall the IO? Why fall the IO?
Great job, guys. Great job. Let's hear it. Yeah, very nice. Very nice. We've got all the traditional Irish music going on for you today.
They only play for 20 seconds?
We're going to be going back to Denny O's in New York, and then we'll be shooting out to FH Riley's on Long Island. And I tell you, we're just doing it all through the magic of radio.
Mm-hmm. The magic of radio, huh?
Yes.
It's such a wonderful medium, one-on-one. Happy St. Paddy's Day to you.
I'm so glad we haven't interviewed the young, rather sexy intern with the good body. Just glad that the fucking monster gets to come in here with some thing from Monsters, Inc., whatever she wants. I forget we talked to the young ones. Oh, what size are those? Why would we? Those look rather heavy. Natural. Yeah, I'm sure they are. You're young, 21. Where do you live? Not a word, not a peep. I don't even know her name. Not a peep
not
out of her.
Not a peep.
Why would we? Why would we sexy to show up? But that fucking wildebeest shows up. We can't get her in fast enough. Come on in with your putrid jacket. Talk for an hour.
Oh, shit.
Oh, man. Anyway, I guess we should do some material here today. Whoa.
Oh, what's going on in
there? Yeah, go ahead.
All right.
Oh, okay.
What?
We could listen to her screening phone calls.
Oh, she's screening?
But she's not doing anything yet.
And what did you, where are you at?
Where are you at?
Atlantic City.
Okay, then. All right. Is she typing? Is she getting good calls?
The what, baby?
What?
No!
Oh, her baby. Oh, the pregnant.
Wait. Okay, I got the bit.
Yeah.
All right. We gotta hang up on everyone.
Are you serious? Don't make me put that in the computer.
Everyone has to start calling right now to congratulate her on her baby.
All right, and then we'll
immediately
hear
it. And we'll hear her responding to that. Okay. I'm gonna hang up on everybody. I'm sorry.
I'm letting her.
But if you call in right now, congratulate Lady Di on her baby.
Are you there?
Hi, Lady Di. I was on it. She just answered.
Really?
Answer phones.
Owen A, what's your name?
Didn't do it. Try again.
Oh, no.
There you go.
Owen A, what's your name?
The delay has
Hello?
To kick in. This
Ramon?
Will take a little bit.
Where are you from, Ramon?
Oh, no. She's taking a call from Ramon.
Where?
What's wrong with you?
Okay.
I'm going to call the hotline.
She's typing in Ramon.
What do you want to talk about?
Answer the next one. If they hang up, don't worry about it. Just go right to the next call. You got it, Dad. Don't worry. You're doing well.
Owen A, what's your name?
His encouragement makes
me
want to smash his face.
No. Any baby calls yet?
Okay.
No, wrong box.
Lines are
mine too. Mine too, Dad. Hey, Di. Here, let's hang up on this one. Let's try another one.
All right. Owen A, what's your name?
Hey, how you doing? My name's Lyle.
Lyle?
Yeah, I wanted to congratulate you on your baby.
Okay.
Hey, I want to talk to Opie and Anthony.
Wait, hold on a second.
Hold on a second. You're not letting me finish. I want to talk to them.
Okay.
What am I supposed to talk to them about?
I don't know what we're talking about.
No, but I want to ask a bunch of questions.
He wants to ask a lot of questions.
Wait, what do you mean? No, I want to ask questions. Say, I want to talk about the Malaysian situation.
Okay.
And then what? Stop typing. Excuse me, miss. What are you doing?
I'm typing.
Yeah, but you're typing real slow and loud.
All right.
I hate your deliberate typing.
All right, I'm going to put you on hold, okay?
Wait, hold on a second. You didn't tell me what the process is. Hunk of garbage.
All right. This one?
Mm-hmm.
Owen A, what's your name?
You didn't pick it up. You didn't even put the other one on hold yet.
I'm not even on hold. She's just picking up a phone. She knows she's picking.
She's hanging up.
Owen A, name, please.
I'm still on.
Huh?
Cool.
I think now she's talking about.
Where
hey,
you from, Tony?
Di.
What?
There's a problem with the mechanism on the phones.
Yeah.
So we connected your headset to Opie. So you don't have to type anymore. Just repeat what they want to talk about. Okay? So you don't have to type. You say, what do you want to talk about? And then
because that's taking too much time.
Yeah.
Well, do I press some buttons?
Because she types with one finger.
One finger typing.
One finger.
All right, the phones are lit, so now we should get baby calls, finally.
Yeah.
Well, this guy, I should put him on hold, right?
No, just say
what does he
want
to say?
I don't even... what'd you say? Am I going to eat my baby? Nah, I'm not pregnant.
I'm going to eat my baby.
All right, move to the next one.
You fuck.
I think this is Bob Levy.
Bob? Bob? I know who it is.
That's why.
Yeah. Yeah. Bob, listen to me. I am not pregnant, okay? I already know who it is. What?
Listen to her wheezing.
What is it, ma'am?
She is wheezing.
Thanks. I know. Happy St. Patrick's Day to you, too.
Move on to another call?
Yeah.
Let's move on to another one, Doc.
She's dangerously bloated.
Yeah.
Hi. How you doing?
It's edema.
Yeah.
She's got edema.
I could listen to this all day.
Oh, yeah.
What? you. I cannot understand what you're saying.
Go to the next one.
Hello, Owen A. Yes? Oh, you want, thank you very much.
Just repeat what they say. Repeat exactly what they say.
Congratulations on the baby. Owen A, what's your name? Hi, how's everything? You want to talk about the guys and stuff about wild elephants?
Go to the next one. Say hello.
Owen A, what's your name?
What do you say?
Congratulations on my baby, you monster. Owen A, what's your name?
Can't they put it on speakerphone so we can hear the listeners too?
Hi, John.
Hmm. Okay.
How are you? What do you want to talk about?
We might be able to fix that for later.
Oh, thank you very much.
What do you say?
What do you say?
Congratulations on my upcoming baby.
Okay, next one.
There. Owen A, what's your name? My baby is not going to come out of my butt. Don't worry about that. You're welcome. Owen A, what's your name?
They call me Happy. Congratulations on the baby.
Oh, thank you.
You sound so fucking hot on this radio. Are you available?
Thank you so much. I sound so fucking hot on the radio.
Next one.
Owen A, what's your name?
Hello?
Hello?
Is this lady Di?
I hope so.
Yeah, well, I just wanted to congratulate you as well. How long has that baby been swimming around in that fetus?
The baby's been swimming around in the fetus for about 7 months, what? Like Opie said.
Idiot caller. Dummy. Fucking dummy. Yeah. Got it all wrong.
Charlie.
Hi, Charlie. How you doing?
Hey, I just want to congratulate you on your baby. That's great. Is the father a water buffalo or an elephant?
The father is a water buffalo. Owen A, what's your name?
Buffler.
Owen A, what's your name? Hello?
Buffler.
This is
Funkus
O'Reilly.
Hi, Funkus O'Reilly. How are you today?
I'm well. I just wanted to make sure that you were aware of fetal alcohol poisoning, you pig.
Oh, fuck.
Fetal alcohol poisoning.
Next one.
Owen A, what's your name?
Andy.
What's your name
I
again?
I know, when you went to the zoo, what gorilla fucked you to give you that baby?
I forgot the gorilla's name.
Oof.
Yeah. Owen A, what's your name?
Quarter buffler.
Hey, buffler. Congratulations, Lady Di. You and Bogo are going to be so fucking happy.
Bogo?
I cannot wait to see what this fucking disaster is going to look like. How's it going to be born?
Bobo and I are going to have a baby, Opie.
Next one.
Who ripped a fart, Jimmy?
Oh. Owen A, what's your name?
Die, who the fuck would stick it at you?
Oh, Jesus.
Terrible.
Did you hear that, Opie? Who would stick it at me? Owen A, what's your name?
Hey, this is Tom. I just want to say congratulations, Die.
Oh, thank you.
I heard you're having a baby. You going to name it Natty Ice?
Probably. That's a nice name. Jeez. Natty Ice is going to be my
this
baby.
This improv is fantastic.
Owen A, what's your name?
Hey, it's Mike.
Hi, Mike.
Hey, I'm your baby. Can you wrap a coat hanger around my head?
Wrap a coat hanger around his head. Owen A, what's your name?
Hello, Di? Is that you?
Yes, it is.
Di, I'm such a big fan. Can I talk to Owen A? Is that cool? Cool with you?
You sound like you speak French. What is this?
What?
Owen A, what's your name?
Jason.
Hi, Steven.
Yeah, I just want to congratulate you on you being pregnant.
Sure, no problem.
I think this has ran its course.
Yeah.
Hello, Owen A, what's your name?
Yeah, right. Ugh.
Next one.
Owen A, what's your
one
name?
More.
You fat fucking wildebeest.
Next one.
Oh, what's your name?
People are just mean.
Just mean.
Be not, I would love them to call up and be nice to her and complimentary. Yeah.
I've had one too. They're not that bad.
What?
That's funny.
Oh, but hey, what's your name?
Lady
Di. Yes. Your name, Neeson.
Listen to me. You're going to be taken.
The men are going to come with sashimi and dip it in the
scout. So congratulations on the baby.
Thank you very much. You're
going
to be
taken.
Owen A., what's your name?
All right, next one.
Owen A., what's your name?
Good morning, Lady Di. Paul.
Good morning, Paul.
I was calling to see what monkey's member you're going to name your baby after.
Oh,
what
boy.
Monkeys I'm going
to
name my baby
after? Nervous Nelly.
All right. There you go.
Do you have that drop where she said water buffalo?
I love that water buffalo.
I can get it.
Please sure, do. That made me so happy.
Water buffalo.
God, what a yacht.
Oh, she is adult.
Yeah. All right.
Good for her.
Her internship's off to a good start. She got the food. She's phone screening pretty well.
Oh, yeah.
Eventually, Jimmy will need something today, and she'll go out and get that.
Yep.
Yeah.
We could talk about the Malaysian flight. I cannot believe we went a whole weekend with no real new information.
Nothing really. There's some little details that came in on electronic stuff and satellites.
Right.
And pinging.
It's crashed. I was wrong about I agreed with the thing, but I think you were right about your theory about...
You think he ditched it?
Yeah. Just let the cabin pressure go away and then just flew, and they all were unconscious, and they crashed in the Indian Ocean.
And just waited for the fuel to run out, which could have been 6, 7, 8 hours. Imagine. Or imagine the pilot was alive and decided, I'm just going to enjoy the last 8 hours of my life just flying into nowhere.
And then he might have just taken the mask off at the end, sure.
Right. I think they're going to find it deep in the Indian Ocean somewhere.
If they find it, yeah.
And he had some T-shirt.
That was nothing. It was just a political shirt about democracy is dead. And the guy he followed some like radical opposition guy who was jailed for 5 years due to homosexuality this week.
Ooh.
So I think this whole thing was a depressing protest against the Malaysian government. He was going to hit the country hard. That's just an opinion. And I also think that... he wants his family to be able to collect life insurance, so he's not going to commit suicide. Like, we're making an obvious suicide. Mm-hmm. If they find the black box, they know what it was.
Oh, right.
So that's why he's hiding the black box. And but the suicide plot, the terrorist plot wasn't crazy at all.
No.
Well, it's still on the table, kind of.
Yeah, but no, I think this is much more likely. They said it's been 10, between 2002 and 2012, there were 10 pilot suicides, Egypt Air, and usually they're not... people have the officials have a really fucking hard time saying yes, this was a pilot suicide. I think they're afraid of because the FAA is basically their job is to promote the airline industry. It's the NTSB you got to listen to. Right. So I think that a lot of times they're afraid it's going to hurt the airline industry by saying that there are pilot suicides.
Yeah, and it is kind of hard to tell for sure if it even was, depending on how they do it. That
we still got to find a piece of the plane.
That's just it.
To put everybody at ease. Pretty much most of the world at ease.
Lack of debris.
But if he went
230 people.
If he went all the way out there, though.
30,000 feet? I mean, 10,000 feet?
If he flew for 7, 8 hours into the Indian Ocean, that's going to be a tough find.
Never going to find it.
Well.
Something will float, though, but.
It's just it. You got to find a piece of it.
Right.
I mean, you know.
Until then, all the theories are still on the table, I would assume, right?
Got to find a piece of it. The black box, that thing is pinging out there somewhere.
How long is it pinging for, a month?
They said 30 days.
Days.
But they said that one that they picked up 2 years later from that Air France thing was still throwing off a signal.
Oh, what?
2 years later.
Wow, no kidding.
So, yeah.
What do you think, Ant? You think terrorism still?
I don't know. That angle seems to be kind of...
Well, you scared everybody on Friday, and now it's...
Well, you know what? It's still there, but I mean, the suicide thing does seem to make a little more sense logistically.
And you adjust as more facts come out, that's all.
Yeah. I don't know, though. This, you know, a piece of a plane would be a nice thing. Yeah, something.
They were on a two-minute loop, pretty much, on all these news channels all weekend long.
Yeah.
It was 2 minutes... They would start
same
over
info.
Again, same exact info.
Yeah.
And then maybe a tiny piece would trickle in, and then they would go with that for hours on end. I finally gave up and just was like, all right, I'll turn on CNN every couple hours just to see if they found anything. Yeah.
Well, he said he told the air traffic control good night after they had shut off the transponder.
Right.
Which is odd.
Right.
You know, he wouldn't say, hey, by the way. And why didn't air traffic control like say, hey, your transponder's down?
I don't
know. Could you give us a little fucking something here?
How long after that was? I'm sorry. How long after that was it? Do you know?
That what?
That he said that from when it was turned off.
It wasn't long at all. It was a few minutes. This
selfish guy.
Yeah.
Killed himself with everybody on board.
Selfish piece of garbage. Instead of faking a car accident. Instead of faking a car accident. Although he maybe wanted the airline to pay it, but.
I read this morning, right before you guys went live, that Malaysia Airlines now believes that the co-pilot was the one who spoke the final words to ground control.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Maybe it was a religious thing for him. Because he's 27, I don't see him being as political. Maybe the young co-pilot.
You're not going to talk two pilots into committing suicide, so what happened between those guys? You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
There's no way you're going to talk both guys into committing suicide.
God, maybe it was a fucking co-pilot. Because he's the one that lived with his family. He was 27. One of them's older with a wife and kids, and one's 27 lives with his family.
Yeah, I don't want to know my pilot still lives with his family.
I don't know.
I'd like to think these guys have more responsibility than that. So, where we're at today.
And this thing, the problem is there really didn't seem to be that much going on when the plane disappeared in the first place. The second that plane disappeared, where the fuck was air traffic control trying to get in touch with them? Trying to get in touch with other planes that might have been in the area that would have seen something. Like, it doesn't seem like they did anything.
Maybe they did.
There's not. How about sending something out to try to find it at its last location? Something.
Right.
I don't know. This seems to be like Malaysia fucked up or whatever it is. Not Malaysia. Wherever the fuck the whoever's zone they were in.
Right.
Wherever they were supposed to talk to the air traffic controllers there. It seems like they dropped the ball.
And they went all the way up to 45,000 feet and all the way down to what? Did they go all the way down to 5,000 feet, I heard?
I don't know. Yeah, that seems...
Why go all the way up to 45,000 feet, Anthony?
Well, if you want to kill your fucking passengers, you could do that.
Would that kill them instantly or just knock them out?
Yeah, it would kill them.
Okay.
You can't breathe up there. That's... How much higher than Mount Everest is that? And you're not getting acclimated to it. You're just fucking, all of a sudden, you're all fine and dandy sitting in a nice warm cabin with the...
That's way higher than Mount Everest, by the way.
Yeah.
16,000 feet higher.
You're just dead.
Yeah.
Yeah, you'll probably just pass out really quick. Keeps the people from making phone calls or jotting things down or, you know, shit like that. Or wondering where the fuck you're going.
Or trying to overtake the cockpit.
Right.
So this guy goes all the way up to 45,000 feet, killing everybody, basically.
Yeah.
And then...
Dips back down to get underneath radar.
Right.
And flies out, all the way out to the fucking middle of the ocean.
Into the middle of nowhere. Does he ride it all the way to the end, or does he kill himself and just leave it on autopilot?
I would assume if you're going to go to that extent, why take the chance that... The plane's going to crash a lot sooner than you wanted it to.
Right.
If you're knocked out and just put it on autopilot, or somebody kind of intercepts you and they look in or something and see, because they could look in the window.
Yeah, but there's nothing they're going to be able to do at that point.
They can't do anything or see anything.
Well, they can't do anything, but you don't want... If you're doing this, you're doing it because you don't want to tip your hand as to what you're doing.
Right.
You know, you want it to look like the plane disappeared or an accident or something.
Right.
But if he's trying to kill himself for insurance money, you don't want them to know that you did that. So I would think you'd want to be in control of the plane as long as you can, so you could bring it as far and as out in the middle of nowhere as you can.
And make it look like it was hijacked or something.
Under 23,000 is avoids radar?
No, you got to be lower than that. Oh,
okay.
They
said as low as 5,000 feet.
Yeah.
That's pretty low.
It is pretty fucking low.
That's pretty low.
And over the ocean, too. You're really...
Right.
There's really nothing out there. Man.
Knowing that. How long of a trip is it across the Indian Ocean? Like, that's...
Hour and a half, I believe.
Oh, I would have thought that. And that's by foot.
Yeah. I don't know. That Indian Ocean's a big one. That's a biggie. They're all big. That's why they're oceans.
Yeah. Crazy.
Knowing you're going there to fly into the water.
Well, he was, you know, if he was bummed out, I don't think he cared.
What a cock.
You can't take that many people with you.
When are these planes going to start flying themselves officially?
Mm.
We're pretty close.
Person in there.
Anyone else see 60 Minutes last night on the drones?
Pretty cool.
I was. Did you see it, Ant? I was thinking of you, man. They had your drones all over the place. But then they were showing other drones that looked like birds and stuff. And
yeah.
From a slight distance, you would swear it's a bird that's kind of fluttering around. And they were talking about the, they were at some kind of trade show and they were showing off the new helicopters.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, these helicopters that fly themselves. Let's say there's an accident and you got to fly, you know, fly someone out of there to a hospital.
Uh-huh.
This helicopter would go to the spot on its own, nobody in it.
Right.
You, as the paramedics, would load the injured person into the helicopter, and now it flies with no one in it back to the hospital.
That's pretty creepy.
How fucked up is that? With enough room if you do need someone in there, but there's no pilot. And they're saying this will absolutely happen within our lifetime.
Yeah.
No windows on the helicopter, by the way, either, which makes it really creepy. It looks like a helicopter without anything. If you could find that clip, it was pretty amazing.
Yeah, what if you want to look out the window?
And they said
people hi.
They said 1 in 5 people within the next few years will have a drone.
Yeah.
Mostly to just fool around and get it up in the sky and go, oh, look at my hometown.
My case photography.
Look at this. This is kind of cool.
Yeah. The electronics now are just amazing.
And they were having a discussion how to, you know, privacy issues and stuff and how do they control it. And mm-hmm. I'm yelling at my TV. I'm like, you're not going to be able to control this stuff.
Nope.
When this type of technology hits us so strong and so hard, it's impossible to do the privacy thing. It's over, Johnny.
Yep.
They're making a shitload of these drones every single day.
Oh, hell
people
yeah.
are buying them like crazy.
It's the electronics are a lot cheaper now.
Right.
They're a lot more efficient, too. It's just fucking amazing.
Yeah, they pretty much showed the one you've been using.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
The GPS is,
Right. Oh, yeah.
That's all you need.
And Morley's there.
Morley Schaefer.
Who has seen it all, but he was just amazed by the drones. They're in a field.
Yeah.
And the guy just takes the drone and goes, look, you know, with the GPS, like Ant just said, look, I can move the drone. He's just pulling it. Like across the field, not across the field, but you know, I don't know, 20, 30 yards away.
Yeah.
Goes, watch. As soon as I let go, that thing will go right back to where it's supposed to be.
Where it was. Where, yeah.
And Morley's just like, wow.
That's amazing. That's quite amazing.
Who's been on 60 Minutes since we were kids, I believe.
Yeah. He's melting.
And he's not even that old. I think he's like 80. I thought he'd be older, I guess.
Yeah.
They live a long time on that show, though, don't they?
Yeah, that's a show you die on, basically.
Steve Schaefer's like the young, good-looking one.
Yeah, you don't retire from that show. You just go until your life is over.
That's pretty much it. Oh, yeah, this guy's saying...
What?
They use that helicopter technology to get people off battlefields.
Really? They're actually using them already?
Well, not yet, but they're... They're figuring it out because you don't want to endanger another guy.
Right, of course.
So you just send a drone.
And I got to say, I was completely wrong with the delivering packages thing.
Yeah.
According to 60 Minutes, they're like, nope, this is a reality, and they will use drones to deliver your packages, to deliver your pizza. They said it's absolutely coming. Remember that commercial? It was like, oh God, who's believing this? But they're this is definitely something that could happen.
I think at some point they'll get that down. Better than that little fucking fat kid that delivers my pizza.
Oh, come on, he works here. I can't stand.
This fucking guy is so goddamn annoying. He comes to the door with the pizza.
He's your regular guy?
Yeah.
Same guy?
Every time.
Okay.
And it's like, I go, how much? You know, how much? And he tells me, and I give him the money, and I go, you got change? Like, or, you know, give me a 5 back. He goes, all right, hold on. And then he trudges back to his car.
No.
And he digs around, and then he comes back with the 5.
No.
It's like, first of all, I don't know what concerns you have, but, you know, this isn't the project.
Right.
I don't think you have to worry about being jumped in this neighborhood. You just come to the door with some fucking change, you little fat guy.
You know what that is?
What?
Because if they go, do you have change? He might just like, no, he has probably better tips that way.
Keep the tip. Yeah, well, fuck him. He's not.
Yeah, as soon as he starts walking away, your move is supposed to be like, oh, forget it.
Yeah, I don't do that.
Do you ever say to him, why don't you, you know the same thing every time, why don't you keep it?
No.
How much is the pizza?
Well, it's not the same every time. It's always, you know, like over the week, this weekend, a lot.
A lot of pizza deliveries.
Like, well, pizza, food, all kinds of other shit.
What's your pizza of choice?
I do like me a standard cheese pie, my friend.
Gotta throw those pepperonis on there, no?
Well, you know what?
What do you like on your pizza?
Give us a call. I like a half pepperoni and then half meatball. That's good, too. That and then some fucking, like, chicken rolls and some ziti and stuff.
What's a chicken roll?
It's like a chicken with some cheese and stuff.
Right.
And it's baked inside some kind of doughy shit.
Right.
Goes around it.
Mm.
Yeah.
I like a filter fish.
It's just what an awful person. Like, he just eats awful things. He can't speak properly. His teeth are dry.
He loves gefilte fish.
Oh, gefilte fish.
My in-laws love the anchovies.
Oh. That just ruins anything it's on because it's too salty and fishy.
Everything
becomes salty and fishy.
Don't eat them right out of the can. I'm like, oh my God.
Disgusting.
What? Why do people like anchovies? I know people love salt in general, but
yeah,
you want to talk about fishy.
They're gross.
Fishy. Oh, my God.
So it's like, oh, you get anchovies on the pizza. Oh, so I can have this anchovy-tasting fucking shit.
The juice finds a pizza river and goes onto your slice.
Exactly. It just stinks.
That is the episode, Sam, but further in, if you need help there. Let's say hi to Christy in Iowa. Christy.
Hey, how you doing?
Pretty good.
Hey, how are you?
I have an issue with the drones. I'm a helicopter flight nurse.
Oh.
And, you wouldn't catch me in one of those. And second, I have an issue with all these drones flying around. We have enough problem with traffic getting in our area and in our space, downing our helicopter. Having those drones fly around and coming into a rural hospital or coming into an accident scene and having to worry about drones flying around to take us out, I'm not happy about that.
I understand, but I don't know how they're going to get around it. I don't know how you stop this technology.
Again, on the battlefield,
and
I can see that.
And I hope that Lady Di has an epidural.
Oh,
yeah, that's
epidural.
Nice.
Yeah, that would be nice so she doesn't feel the pain when she delivers her baby.
Yeah, so she feels good. She's laughing. We talk to her.
Breaking news, Lady Di is pregnant. Congratulations to her.
Yeah, it's really weird her age.
She's about 7 months along. Right. So, Danny, you wish her nothing but the best. You're not going to say anything horrific about Lady Di's pregnancy, right?
All right.
What's that?
Can you come back? Nothing at all. We'll play some nice baby songs for her. But you know, up there on the Denny Vision now, coming Denny in live Vision. Via satellite, we have to get one of the greatest Irishmen of all time. Fucking pluralizing dunce. What's that? He's ready to go? Live from Belfast? How about some Jackie Wilson for you this morning? What will Jackie Wilson send from Van Morrison?
Smooth, Denny, smooth.
Ah. This isn't an Irish song, is it?
Danny spinning the tunes for St. Patrick's Day.
Yes. Yeah. Making this isn't an Irish song.
No.
Is it?
Van Morrison's Irish, though.
Oh, well. All right, Irish artists, some St. Paddy's Day songs. All right.
It's a bit of a stretch.
Yeah, but, you know.
All right, Sam found the part on 60 Minutes about the drones.
Oh, there's a little drone.
There's a beautiful shot coming up right after the Times Square.
Very nice.
Look at what happened. Oh, did you skip ahead? Interesting is that people. Yeah, that shot. Look at that beautiful shot.
Oh, the waves. Yes, surfers.
And scent grows weaving their way.
See, Sam, I can't see stuff.
Anyway.
Weaving their way.
Wow, he sounds old.
But you, I mean, messing with your drone, you see how efficient those things are.
It's amazing. They're fucking
You tell it
amazing.
Where to go, it goes exactly to that spot.
It goes right there.
So the helicopters are only, they're just giant drones.
Versions of,
So of course it's possible.
How cool is that? Just go filming, make movies?
Yeah.
Here's my aerial.
Dude, everyone's using them in their production.
They are.
In their productions now.
Saves all that helicopter rental.
Everyone's
cost.
Using them. Even Jerry, the whole comedians in cars getting coffee, they used a drone to get some cool aerial shots.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you know how much fucking Kubrick probably wishes he had one for the opening of The Shining?
Yeah,
so
right.
That little shadow.
That helicopter.
Even though he's dead.
Yeah, look how fucking amazing that is.
That's
said,
great.
You know, farmers could use them to, you know, check out their crops to see what part of their land is, you know,
land
drying
surveys.
Out. Or
land surveys, sure.
Oh, that shit. Well, of course.
Fires.
Oh, God, yeah, the firefighters?
Yeah.
They can be 200 feet in the air looking at this fire. Where is it moving? There's a ton of environmental uses to fly around after an earthquake or after a flood and see what the damage is and you know, who needs help.
Indeed. After the 2011 tsunami in Japan damaged a nuclear reactor, drones flew in to measure radiation when it was still too dangerous for humans.
Too dangerous.
After last year's typhoon in the Philippines,
it's depressing to hear
they
them.
Surveyed the devastation
around forever.
Flying lower than any helicopter or plane could do.
We have a saying that we build unmanned systems for the four Ds. That's the dirty, dangerous, difficult, and dull missions.
Michael Toscano presides over the world's biggest trade show for drones.
Oh, here
he
comes
the
trade
Association
show.
For Unmanned Vehicle Systems.
Wouldn't you love to go to a drone trade show?
Yep.
You don't like people calling them drones.
Well, drones is a... Most people, when they hear the word drone, think of something that's military.
A UAV.
Something that's large, something that's weaponized, something that's hostile. And that's not what we're talking about.
I'll call them drones.
You can call them drones.
Come on in. Do you know about us?
To the first-time visitor, the drone show is part sci-fi... Oh. Part video extravaganza, and part old-fashioned sales pitch, reflecting the steady movement of the technology.
Send the young guy.
The military drone store.
They did.
Manufacturing of these systems is a whole new
minutes, you're right.
So these are new jobs that are being created.
The big defense contractors are here, but so are the gadget guys and the software developers who write the code for piloting or simply monitoring unmanned aircraft from the ground.
We actually are moving from a Tom Cruise Top Gun persona into the geeky Revenge of the Nerds persona, right?
We tour the floor with Missy Cummings, a former Navy fighter pilot, now a professor in charge of drone research at both MIT and Duke University.
He laughed at
She's become
I heard
an expert
gurgling.
On teaching new drones new tricks. Just give me a sense of how big this industry is as we speak.
Most of the dramatic leaps in technology will now be happening in the commercial sphere. We will see small drones that deliver wedding cakes. We will see large drones that wedding deliver cakes. Your FedEx packages. We will see medium-sized drones that do air quality management.
There's something spooky about no windshield.
It is spooky, right?
This experimental medevac chopper can be programmed to fly itself if need be. An onboard pilot is optional.
This helicopter will take itself off, navigate itself, land itself, and then you will load that injured person in, and it will fly off to the back to the trauma center all by itself. This kind of helicopter in the future will be how first response missions are done all over the world.
So put your styrofoam gadget together.
Sure.
On the other end of the scale, it takes just a minute or so to assemble the Skate, an almost lighter-than-air drone equipped with night vision.
Wow,
American
damn.
Troops in Afghanistan use it to seek out enemy forces. And weighs...
It weighs just about 2 pounds.
Nothing, I would say nothing.
Yeah.
The common denominator in the world of most drones is the camera. Small drones deliver perfect high-definition pictures.
Yeah.
Fucking CD
tape deck. And more sophisticated cameras are able to track vehicles and people from great distances.
Wow.
Looking around the hall, our crew had the sense once again... that the future was looking back at
facial
them.
Recognition.
The issue that really comes to mind is the issue of privacy.
It's very sci-fi.
I mean, these machines are all peeping Toms.
All sensors are peeping Toms. And so anything that you have that's electronic
show
is
me
a
your
Tom.
Fiery
I would say
red
probably
bull.
Your greatest privacy invasion is your cell phone, if not your Facebook account.
That's true.
Yes, there potentially are flying cameras everywhere.
What's the difference, right?
In many cities, there are cameras everywhere.
Cummings and others argue that, like it or not, we live in a surveillance society.
That is true, you know.
That using
got
a drone
phones.
For pictures is no different than using
we gave up on our
binoculars.
We gave up on our privacy a long time ago.
Yeah.
others are
not happy
sure
about it, but we did.
Privacy concerns are very, very major.
Who's this guy?
Dianne Feinstein is chairman of the Senate Intelligence Committee, which oversees spying at home and abroad. She's a defender of the NSA's controversial telephone tracking, but is troubled by the proliferation of drones over America.
He can't control his salivary glands anymore, I think. That seems to be his issue.
Yeah. And the question is, how does it all get sorted out? What is an appropriate law enforcement?
That's a good question.
For a drone? Mm. When do you have to have a warrant? When don't you have to have a
warrant?
Great
questions.
What's the appropriate
I wish he would answer it by pulling his cock out and slapping her mouth.
A recent government report says the FBI has been using small drones in very limited circumstances for the last 7 years.
Stop saying yeses.
To track suspects, photograph crimes. Customs and Border Protection, which operates unarmed predator drones along the border.
This would have been an amazing piece if you had like a young, hip
reporter. Adding some energy to it.
Instead of the way out.
Yeah, giving us the latest on drones.
Picture a benefit to society. When does it become stalking? When does it invade privacy? How close to a home can a drone go?
For Feinstein,
it just keeps going.
Yeah,
unfortunately, it does. Speaking of droning,
Morley safer.
Poor Morley.
Cool.
It is cool. How's your drone? You got to update it?
It's too fucking cold to do anything.
Will you be updating it? It seems like there's even more.
I know, that's just it. It's like
more
kinds
technology,
of new technology
out there. Look, there's the bird one.
Yeah, wow. Looks like a bird.
How messed up is that?
Are getting smaller. There's one that looks like a hummingbird. Another that flaps its wings like a dragonfly.
Oh my gosh.
Once this dragonfly out of the bottle. Cool. How do you stop
them? Now, it still looks very mechanical, but that's like the first generation. You imagine they then take that and go, okay, no, we can make this look smoother and sleeker.
Imagine when they're the size of house flies and gnats.
Yeah, that's a big thing.
Wow!
You just fly it into someone's window and fucking look around their house.
Privacy is going to be, I told you, a thing of the absolute past.
We're all fighting for it, but I'm going to lose that battle, I think.
That's the one I got.
That's what I said. I said
yours is so big.
That's exactly it.
It is, right?
Yeah,
it's crazy.
Are already out there in the marketplace.
Yes.
Governments don't just get to have drones now. Your everyday person can go buy a drone on
the internet. That's right. That's right, bitches.
I find that scary, quite honestly.
A little scary. You know, and I'm always worried that my students are trying to fly a drone over to my office window and peek in on me.
I don't see this technology getting any better in the next few days.
I'm willing to accept
Morley. Yeah, or Morley.
Jesus. No, but I'm telling you, what kind of secrets will be safe in any way? Once they're the size of flies and gnats, they'll have to detect the electricity. Electronics in certain areas.
So when will a drone be at your front door? It makes for great fun on YouTube videos, as in this spoof from Netflix. But the idea of Amazon or FedEx or indeed Domino's doing home deliveries in the next couple of years is just pizza pie in the sky. There are too many issues.
I'm like to mush a hot pie in his face.
Scolding. In the meantime,
look at that thing.
Time and technology wait for no one.
What by the way, this video they'll be watching the way we watch 1950s videos about the houses.
Yeah. One in five people.
Yeah, the
this is this guy. He looks like a bird.
Camera that they can use to take aerial photos and videos.
One in five people have drones.
And as with any technology, new uses tend to pop up that nobody could foresee. On our Sunday in the park with drones, we discovered that man never needs to exercise the dog again. Just stick the drones on it.
Oh, Morley.
Oh, Morley. It can even change a diaper.
I bet that stopwatch at the beginning of the show has a new meaning for him.
60 days.
Morley.
Well, I think he's getting... he's born in 1931, by the way.
31.
He's 83. 83, yeah.
Wow.
83-ish?
Yeah.
How about that?
Wow.
I don't think the privacy issue is that big a deal because we've already given everybody the ability to just record us no matter what we're doing or what we are.
I mean taking a shit. Every private conversation that you just speak to someone can be now. Once they're that teeny tiny thing, forget it.
But future generations will just be used to it. It'll just be what it is.
It'll even
it's weird for
us because we know it a different way. You know what I mean? Yeah. Eventually, people will be like, privacy? What was that all
privacy.
About?
Privacy, oh, that sounds
it's
like
it's primitive a in a weird way.
Amazing.
Privacy. Right.
Yeah.
It'll be okay when we lose it.
And then that damn 60 Minutes really, really is a great show. I just get depressed because of how old the guys are. I don't know why they don't like kind of young it up slightly, meaning update get some it. Guys in their 50s. Of course, that would be really young for
the
60
kids.
Minutes. Right. They did the Egyptian Jon Stewart guy. They did, and then they did a whole thing on Tabasco. Like, who cares about Tabasco?
Tabasco.
But it's a family business that goes back five generations, and it's made on an island somewhere in Louisiana.
One family?
One family. I was so... If you haven't yet, you know, search out the 60 Minutes piece on Tabasco.
One family makes Tabasco?
One family for five generations.
They gotta be worth like $100,000.
Who approached with that story,
could
though?
Could you, like, just get the beginning of the story? Just because they give you a lot of the basic facts right off the bat, and we don't have to watch the whole thing.
It's a journey where Tabasco is made.
No, they went with the young guy.
Oh, they did.
Yeah, Gupta.
Avery Island was a.
Oh, Sanjay Gupta?
Is caught back and
you go back.
CNN doctor guy.
That's not Sanjay, though.
It wasn't Sanjay Gupta?
Yeah, that's Sanjay.
Oh, he does these pieces.
Yeah. Go back because he explains the island. It's this. Takes you. Oh, what happened?
Stop ruining it, Sam.
Oh, what happened?
Sam.
What happened?
Stop spoiling
it. Oh, Sam.
And I don't like Tabasco.
No. CNN's Sanjay Gupta.
I'm more of a red hot guy. 60 Minutes. Frank.
Tabasco is more than a mere condiment.
Really?
It's an American artifact.
Right.
The sauce was first made in 1868.
Told you.
And within a few years, it was being served in the White House.
Of course it was.
Since then, it's made its way to nearly every country in the world.
Says you.
It's one of America's most prolific exports.
Right.
Which is why we decided to take a closer look.
Did you?
And what we discovered
I'm more into the pre-Tabasco
is that every
era.
Tabasco has been made by the same family.
I like Tabasco, but on a cliff.
Producing their famous sauce, known locally as Cajun ketchup, on their very own private island
private
in the middle
island.
Of Cajun country for five
that's
generations.
What I call period blood on my sheets.
The McElhenney clan
the old
has
Cajun
done
ketchup.
It by adhering to 150 years of tradition in how they make their sauce.
It's also the sign it's time to break up.
They say it publicly. Which is typically very little. Letting 60 Minutes come in
they
with
don't talk about
and
it. They won't give you numbers or nothing.
No.
150 years, same family.
The story will continue in a moment.
Oh. What?
Put it on now. Are they going to have an ad?
Oh, boo.
That's how they do it online. Tabasco sauce, I
boo.
Hope.
Oh. Oh, there it is.
Avery Island is located in the bayous of Louisiana.
Louisiana.
West of New Orleans. Only 2 miles wide, the island has been owned by the McElhenneys and their family for almost 200 years.
McElhenney.
This is where we take our pepper mash.
It's 9 a.m.
Our pepper
that
mash.
That means Tony Simmons, the fifth generation CEO, is heading to the warehouse for his daily taste test.
I love it.
Farmers all over the world grow the peppers, mash them, and ship it all back to Avery Island.
You do this every morning that you're here?
Every morning I'm here. I check these barrels if they're making
He's
mash.
He's tasting Tabasco every
Where's
day.
Every day.
Columbia.
That means every bottle of Tabasco in the world has his personal seal of approval.
Wow. So I'm looking at the color, and that's why I've got an incandescent light. I want to look at the color. I want to look at the seed. And when I taste the mash, usually what
the
I'm
mash.
Looking for is I get some salt out on the edges of my tongue.
Uh-huh.
And then about the time you think, well, this isn't that much of a big deal, the heat comes late. You want to try it?
Sure. I'm watching you first, though. How
I do
it?
This every morning. It's not so bad for me.
Is that a good chunk?
Yeah, that's good. And just put it on the front of your tongue.
You must be so sick of it.
Just let it sit there for a minute.
If you think Tabasco is hot, the raw ingredients are 10 times hotter.
Wow.
The heat kicks in.
I have newfound respect.
Peru.
Why
like
doesn't anyone else make it?
Tastes like candy?
Smells like money.
He explains.
Yeah?
He pauses.
Are there secrets
wow.
in here, though?
He tastes every barrel as fuck?
To know?
Yeah,
crazy.
Man.
He must be so sick of Tabasco sauce.
Right?
They estimate how much the company makes. He goes, that's good, but I'm not going to tell you if it's right or not. You can't get numbers on this company.
Dude, why doesn't...
And they got the name Tabasco. People are making hot sauces all over the place, as we know, but you can't call it Tabasco. You could call it hot sauce.
Okay, sure.
Made with the Tabasco pepper, I think, or something like that. But you cannot use the name Tabasco. They will sue the fuck out of you.
Oh, that's smart.
Damn.
Yeah.
And they grow the seeds on the island, I believe, and then they ship them off to farmers all over the world to grow the actual peppers.
Maybe there's something in that water or whatever that just gives them a good flavor.
I don't know. It's just that they've been doing it for
that crazy
since 1868. And then they got the, and when they get the seeds, they put them in a vault.
Yeah.
And these packages that they now send off to the farmers to, you know, to plant.
Are they responsible for the whole fuck ketchup campaign on Facebook? They were tweeting hateful shit at ketchup under a fake name.
This guy is weird, though, the CEO. He just laughs a lot.
Yeah.
He loves Tabasco. Play it just a little more.
Yeah.
Just a little more.
Mm-hmm. Our formula is only red Tabasco mash, vinegar, and a little bit of salt. So I don't know how many secrets we could really have with a process that's...
They don't give a fuck. They got the name.
It was Simmons' great-great-grandfather, Edmund McElhenney, who created the sauce shortly after the Civil War.
Wow.
He began selling his concoction in old cologne bottles in New Orleans.
Right after the Civil War, probably to splash in the eyes of anyone that moves in next door to him.
Dude, that's why I said pause.
Like, he's going to fire it out.
I know, I should have fired it out.
Yeah,
you know damn well this Tabasco wasn't used for food at first. It was a torture device.
Well,
Now
that they're free.
Right.
Yeah. He handed it out to all the new Negro families and said, if you rub this on your pecker, it makes sex really good.
I wonder, as much as that is a great joke, I wonder if that is what is going on here. And then someone said, wait a minute, this stuff tastes pretty good. What if it tastes pretty good? Right.
Spice it up.
We can do it right here in the airport.
In the airport.
Tabasco right here in the airport.
Damn.
Yeah, because if it's 1868 and it's a hot... It's a hot substance. It's not a sauce yet, I think.
No.
I think this was used for some evil at first.
Let's put this in fire hoses.
Right, exactly. What do you mean it tastes pretty good?
Yeah, that's very interesting.
Well, keep going.
Calling it Tabasco.
There was no commercially sold hot sauce.
See, first hot sauce too?
Edmund invented the category.
He is sort of the father of hot sauce.
He's the father of hot sauce.
That would make this the first family
Godfather
of hot sauce.
Godfather of hot sauce.
That sounds real good.
The first family of hot sauce turned Tabasco into one of the oldest and largest family-owned and operated businesses in the country.
Wow. You're the fifth-generation family member to run this business.
Mm-hmm.
How unlikely a story is this?
Only 30% of companies outlive the founder or move to a second generation, and only 12% of companies actually make it to the third generation. So for us to be the fifth generation and still be doing this is a much smaller subset.
Oh, you know who else is, by the way? You
From
know who
the
else
beginning.
Is? The fucking Jerry and Ellen Mustard.
Mustard.
Really?
Jerry and Ellen Mustard.
Yeah, they started it in 1403.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, and it was an accidental scrimshaw. They were using yellow paint, and one Jerry got so hungry, he ate the scrimshaw.
And it was good.
It was delish.
Wow.
Well, the paint was delish. Yeah.
Look at this. It's always been run by and for family members. The top management, board, and 130 stockholders are all McElhenney descendants.
McElhenney.
Estimates are that the sales are close to $200 million a year.
Wow.
Am I in the right ballpark?
You're probably in the right town. You know.
Could you put me in a better ballpark?
No. We like I said, we just don't give out financial information.
What about margins? Profit margins? Can you talk about that?
Nope.
Wow.
None of it?
None of it. It's a private family-held business.
Is there any advantage to not sharing this information?
We're not sure, but we're probably not going to find out either.
Wow.
Harold
Good for him.
Osborne.
He applies.
Another
the government probably knows on their taxes, right? But
sure.
That's private information.
Yeah.
Is this, and it's probably for kidnapping and shit like that reason.
So.
Is this interesting? Or?
I mean, I don't know if the people want to hear the whole report, but I literally could sit there and watch a movie about this guy.
Really?
Yeah.
That's what I thought. I was like, this is fascinating.
I've never thought about Tabasco in any way, shape, or form. Mm.
And he says, you know, he likes the competition of all the other hot sauces in recent years, at least the last, 10 anyway. A lot of new hot sauces are on the market. And he said, yeah, that we like all that because eventually they'll find Tabasco and we'll have them hooked on our product.
You know what's funny, too, is that, like, that's, you look at that guy. That's not a guy you think makes $200 million a year. So you know how many times like he might go out to Vegas, how you doing? He's like a little old boy, and no idea he could buy and
that
sell
the guy,
everyone in here.
And a lot of the workers, they have Tabasco on every meal, every day.
Oh, God.
The perks of a job could be cool, but I don't know.
No, I don't know absolutely. If
I'd be happy having Tabasco all day long.
No. I'd much rather work in the pocket pussy factory.
Fucking fleshlight.
Yeah, exactly.
It's fucking it every day.
Every day at lunch, there's a bunch of guys in the break room fucking staring at the wall, fucking humping fleshlights. There's a fleshlight vending, a lubrication vending machine.
Thinking to themselves, why couldn't we work at Hershey?
Yeah, exactly.
Eat Tabasco every day.
A delicious place.
They probably say, have all you want.
Yeah. You guys can drink it. They have Tabasco vending machines and ice.
No one cares.
Imagine the bathrooms at this place.
God.
Oh, God. There's 400. There's only two urinals and 400 seated toilets.
just blowing out assholes every day.
Oh, shit.
That is unbelievable.
Wow. Yeah, that's interesting, man. It's like you never think, but where does this shit come from? We just use it every day.
Some are saying Tabasco is worth well over $10 billion.
Wow. Billion?
Come on. And they've been offered a lot of money to sell. And this guy says later...
Dan, recognize me.
Holy shit.
Hello?
Yeah, this is Bobo.
I was in the middle of saying something.
Yeah, you guys put me on.
Exactly. He's correct.
Well,
why are we talking? Why are we talking to this idiot?
I thought you would wait for me to finish. What's going on?
Go ahead. It's all about you.
Yeah. I happen to be downstairs because I have to be at Cal to watch a friend in the parade.
Why are you calling us?
Yeah, I called in because they suggested I called in.
There you go. You can't hint anything to him. He's the worst kid in the West.
No.
So what did he do? He put it in his mouth. That's what I told you to say.
Okay. All right, you're on now. Go.
Yeah. I happen to be downstairs, and I'd also like to say hi to the lady Di. Congratulations on...
She had to go to the hospital, Daniel. She had to go to the hospital.
She might deliver the baby early. She was having some labor pains because she was moving around more than she has in years.
Well, good luck with that.
Anyway, the Tabasco people, you know, they've had offers from huge companies.
And yeah.
This guy hinted like, well, it's up to the board members, but, you know, we're pretty much hoping that we could keep this within the family.
Yeah.
It is creepy, though. It's an island. They make Tabasco. They all live on the island.
Yeah, it's almost like cultish.
It is, right?
Yeah.
All right, Bobo, that was great.
All right, I guess we'll see you guys in a little bit.
Yeah, really? We hope so.
What do you mean? You're coming up here?
Yeah, you're coming. You're also giving out WoW stickers to any fans at the parade who recognize me.
That's good. Oh, to recognize you. It's always about you and your fucking... talking to him.
And where'd you get WoW stickers?
That's where he got them. They're not hard to get. They're a rare item.
All right, get them from out. Somebody get them from out here.
Did you hear the part where Jimmy said, "Who cares where he got them?"
No one cares. That
doesn't mean. Well, now I got to explain where I got them from.
It doesn't matter where I got them. I just got them.
It's true. Ain't where you're from. It's where you're at, right? Right, Bobs.
Bobs. Are there a lot of people milling about down there for the parade?
Question. Yes. Very good question.
Yeah. They probably did.
Who cares? It's a real trifecta today, isn't it?
Probably going to be not
right through.
Probably going to be cold, but not right going to stop people from getting drunk.
It's like a hurricane.
Probably not going to
right through.
I have
no ability to stop. Blend in.
What'd you say they're drinking, Bobo?
I said it's not going to stop from people from speaking in road sodas.
Hey, slipping in some.
Yeah, show vernacular.
Show
is
there.
Yeah,
he's terrific.
Thanks so there's a lot of people down there getting ready.
Yeah.
Dressed up in green?
Yep, pretty much.
Are you?
Well, the headphones I got are green.
Why do you have headphones
thanks
on?
Thanks for the report.
Why do you have headphones on?
Yeah.
Maybe because of listening to the show.
Oh, okay. That would be a good reason.
Cool. To the show. Snotty answer, but he's right.
Yep. Yeah.
Danny, do you like the way he's painting a picture downstairs?
What are you pointing at?
What? Danny.
Hey, Bobo! Nice to see Bobo outside of the bar. Giving out those wow stickers. What bar? There's all these corporations right here. And don't forget, we just got the Xerox machine fixed. We're going to be printing up some of the bracket sheets for the Final Four. Be checking your brackets, right? Final Four is underway. Xerox machine.
In the bar?
Yeah, exactly. Why is there a Xerox in the bar? A lot of festivities going on here this morning.
Copying any girls' asses, too.
That's a good question. Why would we have a Xerox
in the bar?
To print up the menus.
What menu?
Why don't you print them on a printer?
For the food.
Xerox machine making copies.
The printer
making copies. How many fucking menus could there be in a small bar?
Well, it changes from time to time. Seasonal. Seasonal favorites as well.
Because today, corned beef and cabbage, I'm sure.
Shepherd's pie.
Shepherd's pie.
No, you're not going to music right now. All right, Bobo.
Hey, can I enter it too?
No.
Shut up.
Now we know the reason for the phone call. Right. Someone is a bit jealous someone else is getting a spotlight today, little attention.
Yeah, I think I could out-intern Lady Di.
Really?
Lady Di.
How would you out-intern her?
Well, for one thing, I think I could get the orders right.
She got the orders right.
The orders were right.
I could get the orders right.
She got the orders right.
Oh my God. I could also get the phones answered right.
They were answered right.
She answered
that
well.
Phones
right.
Yep.
There was a lot I didn't hear while I was on the train.
Oh, my God.
Did
you say that? Wow.
Okay.
Hi.
Oh no.
I just want to let you know that Bobo cannot say that again.
Oh my God.
Bobo can't be a good intern like I am.
It was supposed to come from you, not say that again.
Yeah, you don't.
Will you put your headphones on?
Right.
Will you put the headphones on?
Bobo can't.
He's on the phone. Put the headphones on so you can hear him.
God. Say it.
Exactly.
You sure you're not pregnant, by the way?
Babe Ruth body.
How you doing?
Is that twins in there?
Could you point and hit me a home run?
The Bambino. Oh, my God.
The Dumbino.
Hello?
Yeah, I also won't slip down the stairs or be exhausted going up and down the stairs.
No.
Cheers. Why are you calling with this shit?
No, I agree. That's because I smoke.
What?
That's why. What?
It's a terrible comeback.
Hi, Bobo. How you doing?
Why would you agree to his slam?
Those tilted fucking glasses.
Right.
I want to punch them off the face.
I also am in a lot better shape.
Those tilty fucking glasses.
Don't worry about my glasses.
Tilty
why
glasses.
Do you got tilty glasses?
Exactly.
Is one ear lower than the other?
Huh?
They're like two monocles.
No.
I'm in a better shape, and I'm not...
Right through.
Oh, wow.
Fucking right through.
It's
selfish idiot.
No. They're old glasses. That's why.
Yeah.
They're old.
So they make them tilty?
No. They're old.
Right through. Plowing right through, Dumbo. Right through. It's all about you, sociopath.
What are you so worried about my glasses for?
Yeah,
because
see, we have to look at you. and it's just this annoying thing
right,
how they're
here,
tilted.
Here. All right, hold on a second. Hold
what,
on.
What,
there,
what?
Now. Better?
Now she
now
put
you
her glasses
see.
There.
I can see.
Why are they all smeary? Have you ever cleaned them?
Filthy.
They're old. They're old.
Wow, they're really old.
They're not old to where they smear.
That might be an ant. They might be antiques.
Look how dirty they are.
My glasses are straight.
Holy shit.
They're old glasses. What can I tell you?
But it doesn't matter. Old doesn't mean they can't be clean. I'm sure Ben Franklin's glasses are on display somewhere, not smudged up like they were put through a fucking oil slick.
Yeah,
holy shit.
Don't you have
insurance? Oh, my God. What?
Excuse me?
Couldn't they cover new glasses?
Bobo, will you go away?
Insurance? No. Not for my glasses. I never had insurance on glasses.
All right.
I don't recall having insurance on glasses.
All right. Okay. Wow. Lady Di, how's your internship going?
It's going fine so far, except for the last part.
What happened with the last part?
The audio thing that I had to do. I don't know what I'm doing over there. Was
wait,
I putting
wait,
in sound bites or something?
We don't know what you're talking about.
What did you make her do?
I walked over to grab Lady Di, and she was sitting at the computer with headphones on, using Adobe Audition to edit audio.
What?
Whereas last we checked, she couldn't figure out how to type right on the phone screen.
You figured out Adobe Audition?
Yeah, I figured out Adobe Audition.
All by yourself?
I know.
Oh, Adobe my Audition. God.
Shut the fuck up. Holy shit, dude. It's amazing how fucking you just don't, after all this time, know how to have a talk.
I'm trying, trust me.
Hey, no, not you. We don't have a problem with you.
Yeah, good, thank you.
Oh, wow.
Oh, my God.
This is so tedious. It's tedious.
Lady Di, I really think you're pregnant, though. You sure?
I'm not pregnant.
When was the last time you got that old period?
Right.
When was the last time you made some Cajun ketchup in your pants?
Almost 2 years ago.
And why are you tearing? You all right?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You got tears coming out of your eyes.
Oh, that's
emotional from the hormones from the baby?
No.
Is that natty ice just leaking out of the system?
Natty ice just...
That could be.
Are you getting hung over yet because you haven't been able to continue your buzz?
No.
What were you doing over on Audition on the computer?
Huh? What was I doing over at Audition? I don't know, like pressing this thing right here.
Spacebar.
Spacebar.
It's called M. Spacebar and M.
Oh.
I have no idea.
Spacebar M. Spacebar M.
Yeah.
Okay.
What were you marking?
I'm marking some comedy show. You were on it.
Thank you.
Yeah. I don't know.
What are you marking for?
I guess for sound bites, right? I have no
idea. You're just randomly hitting.
Yeah, randomly hitting. I don't know what I was doing.
What, Bobo?
Just.
Lathers.
I always shut up.
The space bar and the letter M. Constantly, constantly, constantly. The space bar, then I hit the space bar again, and then you hit letter M.
We heard you.
Stop.
We space
all right, bar
heard you.
What are you hitting with M?
Space bar.
Here
goes
my phone again.
Turn the phone off.
All right, listen.
Are you putting
pictures up?
Yes.
Do we have pictures up yet?
Yeah, there's a
from
bunch.
From Lady Di's first day as an intern?
Could you be useful and read that top thing, please, so I can find a plug in here?
There's a gallery of Lady Di photos on
ONA show
on Twitter and Facebook.
This week, Thursday to Saturday, March 20th to the 22nd.
That's all. Thank you very much.
Good job. Very much.
Well done.
Okay.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
All right, go ahead, Lady Di.
Do I get free tickets for the show now?
Yes, you do.
Bobo, you done?
Yes, I at least goddamn know how to goddamn use the computer.
I know how to use the computer, but not for a radio show.
All right, Bobo, we got to let you go, right?
All right.
Bobo, see you next time. Talk to you later.
I wish a hospice doctor was saying this.
And we have to go to
hold on.
Colin Quinn,
who orchestrated this
and set us down this path. Mr. Quinn.
Happy St. Patrick's Day, everybody.
Hi, Colin Quinn, very Irish.
Hi, Colin. How you doing?
Secretly, hi, Colin is trying to destroy the Opie and Anthony show.
Yes.
I'm calling from OSHA about Diana's glasses.
OSHA.
They're really...
OSHA about my glasses.
I tweeted a picture of them.
Yeah, go to Jim Norton's Twitter. Jim Norton.
Can you see it, the picture?
They're so, like, greasy.
They're not greasy.
They are greasy.
They are.
They're like...
They look like the window in a peep booth.
What?
There you go.
Look at that crust.
There's a lot of crust on them.
No. That's,
That's your glasses.
That's scratches.
And there's crust on it.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah, I wish they were knuckle marks.
Have any Windex?
What are you doing, fucking catching falcons with them?
It's very scratchy.
They are scratchy.
Yeah.
What do you got, Carl?
Nothing. I just called to see how the whole day was going.
Oh, so far, fantastic. So good. Bobo was on the phone.
Yep.
Denny's in studio, and so is Lady. It couldn't be better.
I'm not even next to you, Jim.
Oh my.
I'm not even kidding. This is Jim Norton's nightmare, having all three in at the same time.
Yeah. Why would it be his nightmare?
You should be looking at it more like it shows how the unemployment rate is so terrible that Bobo's fighting over the intern job.
Yeah. It has nothing to do with his insatiable need for attention.
He's a bit jealous that Lady Di got the big spot this week.
So needy.
Please don't be jealous of me.
The big spot. every week.
I like him standing at the parade route like Travis Bickle with his green headphones on.
Why isn't Bobo here?
He's down.
Good board. Question.
Oh, he is?
What time is it for you? An hour earlier? We just covered that.
Okay. Thanks for the nice picture of my glasses.
You're welcome.
What
thanks
about, what about
for
a nice
the
picture of me?
She just did a cheesecake pose. She just did a cheesecake pose.
Hold on. She's wiggly.
Like the 40s. She put one hand behind her head and one hand on her hip.
Hold on.
And she's rocking back and forth.
Hold on, love.
Oh, my God.
You mean sideways, don't you?
That's whatever you're doing.
Are you doing a picture, Jimmy?
Oh, that's fantastic.
Yeah, hold on. Hold on. I'll Instagram.
Holy shit. She looks like nose art on a freighter.
Yeah.
Come on, do it again. I'm taking a picture.
Wow.
She's been flirty all day.
Yes, she has been flirty.
Why not?
Lady Di, if you could sleep with one person on the show, who would it be?
Hubba Hubba.
Yeah.
Or blubba blubba. Maybe that's.
You really want to know?
I want to know.
Sam Roberts.
It's not.
It's Lady Sam Di. Roberts.
I think it's.
No, Sam Roberts is married.
Thank you, Lady Di, for respecting.
Yes.
Married.
But I know one person that's not married over here, and I would like to sleep with him.
Jim Norton.
No, not me.
No. Next to Jim Norton.
Oh, Greg Opie Hughes.
No.
Oh, Danny O'Falcone.
She wants to
Is it Dennis Falcone?
Anthony Okumia.
Yeah.
Hey, has she been to the compound yet?
No.
Why not?
Big A goes to the compound. Bobo's been to the compound.
I have not been to the compound. No.
You just said it. Big A's been to the compound. My quota's fulfilled.
Well, you said it like Big A. So.
Full.
You know, I figured Anthony is single, and I always had a crush on him anyway. So.
Oh, my God.
Crush is the proper term.
What would you want to do to him sexually?
That's a very good question.
Sexually, like, what would you want to do?
Yeah, whatever he wants to do.
No, that's a dumb answer. Cool. Yeah, exactly. I don't think you're going to like to shoot yourself in the vagina.
Lady Di, here's the scenario.
What?
Ants all in. What would you do? What's your move? He wants. What would you do
what
to
would
him?
You want?
What would I do to
nice.
Him? I'd start out by giving him a hug.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, nice.
I like a good hug.
And a nice kiss.
Where?
Oh, do I like that?
Where's the kiss? Slow down.
Right
where?
On the head of my
where?
Cock.
On the neck, right?
Yeah, on
then
the
mouth.
On the mouth, right. On the mouth.
A good tongue kiss, right?
Yeah, good tongue kiss. A good tongue kiss.
Nice natty ice flavored kiss.
Would you lick his lips?
And cigarettes?
Sure I would. If he wanted me to.
He would.
He would. He God, wants
yeah,
that.
Don't keep discourage. Going. You'll listen to them.
Yes.
She wants to lick your lips, Ed. Nice.
I heard that.
Yeah. I wasn't sure you heard
so, it. So while there's a hug happening, go ahead, Di. Go ahead, love.
Let me see. I'm making Anthony blush right now.
Well, that blood's rushing to his fat cock. It's actually rushing from his cock down to his feet.
Then I would slowly take his... clothes off.
Oh.
Ooh, nice.
And then I would have just my laughing. Way with him.
Yes, you mean pull his hood off.
What do you mean by have your way with him?
Have
you can't just
my
say
way.
That.
Opie, please. You know what I mean.
Summon the clan.
I would slowly blow out that cross and pull his robes off.
my phone's probably blowing up right now.
Dad, would you handle his unit?
Yeah. What do you mean?
Man.
What do you mean you would have your way? Like, we need details.
I would have my way with him. In other words, I'd put him down in the bed, and then I would just go start from the top of his head, providing his cap is off, and then I would work my way down to the.
Wait, you start on his scalp?
Yeah, right. What the fuck is this?
I would start from the top of you and work my way all the way down.
What would be your favorite part?
My favorite part. What do you think my favorite part?
Tell him. Say it.
Say it.
It's okay. Say it. He's all right.
Wait. Hold on. I'm just trying to find a nice way of saying it.
Would you eat his ass?
No.
She's
I don't
lady.
Do stuff like that.
But what would be your
I
favorite
do
part?
Like
don't be
that.
Afraid to get dirty, Di.
Go ahead.
His dick. Okay.
Wow.
You really want to know, right?
Yeah. What would you do?
And
with
I never even saw it.
Would you use your mouth on it?
What? You'd use your mouth on it?
Sure.
And then would you climb up and ride it?
Oh, my God.
Yeah, you would, right?
She's sweating. Yeah. Oh.
Would you kiss Anthony?
No, I'm not sweating. No,
What position would you want to be in with Ant?
When you made love.
Monster style.
Yeah, what position?
How about a 69?
With Anthony on the bottom. Yeah. Yes. Anthony on the bottom.
Yeah, with Anthony on the bottom. Right. On the top.
Yeah, that means you got to eat her box out.
You drop your coat right on his mouth, right?
Sure.
That's right.
You think he'd be all
funny?
You think he'd be wet, Di?
Yes.
Yeah.
You would. That would be like 69ing under a garbage truck.
And it'll be the first time I did something sexual in about maybe 5 years now.
Absolutely.
Yeah, all right. Well.
Damn. So, wait, you'd grind on his mouth?
Sure.
Would you come in his mouth? Sure. Discharge come in his mouth? Yeah.
Oh, my God. No, I don't know.
Mm. Would you let it, but if you were discharging, you'd just let it go all over his face, right?
Yeah, why not? Would you let him eat your ass?
No.
You don't like that, huh?
What if you wanted to? What if you wanted to?
No.
No.
You got any roids? Certain things I don't do.
Do you got any roids?
Huh?
Yes, work. Do you got any roids?
I don't know.
Do you got any hemorrhoids?
No, I don't know.
No, I don't know.
I don't think so.
You pop his hog in your mouth while you're grinding on his lips?
Yeah.
Fucking hot. I get it.
Hey,
I'd rather be on flight 307. Or wait, no, it wasn't 307. It's three.
Whatever it is, we understand. You see, I'd rather be on a Malaysian plane.
Yes, so that one, yes.
Very important. Hi, who's this? Hi, who's this?
I gave away too much information, didn't I?
No, it was a good lady die.
All right, yeah,
hello?
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 And maybe it's still Colin on.
Oh, no,
well,
we got Colin.
Colin's there.
We had another special guest on the other line, but they're not saying hello right now.
So you still want to do it, right?
You're setting a bad tone professionally, by the way. A little sexual innuendo. I wish you'd stop it.
Colin doesn't like it.
Yeah, you got to keep this professional.
An intern saying this is, I want to talk to human resources.
Although, could you show Anthony the goods to show him what he's missing?
Show him the boobs, yes.
Please.
Oh, please, don't make me do that again.
What?
Please don't make me do that. Interns don't do that.
Don't do what?
Please.
Show boobs and stuff. Then just
show boobs.
Well, bubs, whatever you want to call them.
Well, right,
guy, be honest. Would you rather fuck in the bed or the hot tub? Be honest.
In the bed.
You would, right?
Yeah.
Why?
Because I like a bed a lot better.
Okay.
Oh my God. Yeah. I think I'm gonna be sick
with the bugs.
You know who she looks like? She looks like the Elephant Man's handler. Remember that rotten guy?
He was a meanie. He was a mean guy.
Yeah. My treasure.
My glasses don't look that bad.
Those are your glasses.
They don't look bad for
a photo of them.
Colin? Yeah.
For things clean with an oil rag, they look good.
So it's going well.
Yeah, it sounds like it's going pretty
good. Looks like she fucking buttered her toast with her glasses this morning.
No.
She goes, no,
you didn't do that?
So you didn't butter your toast with your glasses this morning?
No.
Okay.
She buttered it with a tequila worm.
Ding, 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 ding.
What would it take to see your vag today?
That's not going to happen.
Why?
It's not intern behavior, is it?
That won't happen.
But maybe Aunt goes, oh, wow, what a nice surprise.
And I go
No, that's right. No. I don't do stuff like that.
Yeah, what would it take to see your vag? A sanitation job.
Lady Di. In the old days, you were a little more coy. You were a little more. It was subtle. It was a subtle thing when you used to come in.
How it used to
at
be
at NEW.
Yeah.
And now you just got this whorish slut attitude. There talking about putting cocks in your mouth stuff. I liked the old days a little better when you were a little more refined and quiet and coy about it.
Yeah.
Sure.
Too late.
Say,
you already said, like, you
know. You'll be refined if he slips you that dick, right?
You already said, you know.
Because, yes. I better not.
Our special guest might finally be there.
Oh.
Hi, who's this?
This is Bobo. Hi,
I swear we did not ask him to call back.
Happy St. Patrick's Day. How's the parade?
That doesn't sound like Bobo.
That didn't even start yet, Colin. Happy St. Patrick's Day, Colin.
Shut the fuck up. Amazing.
Wait.
Jimmy, happy St. Patrick's Day. He's Irish too, you know.
That's Bobo.
Bobo, are you inside the building right now?
Yeah, I'm in the lobby.
Why are you in the lobby?
If he doesn't look like a tard in that picture.
Why are you in the lobby?
In any picture.
In any picture.
Go to O&A Show on Twitter to see Bobo just hanging out in the lobby in yellow, by the way.
Are my pictures on the O&A Show, too?
Yes.
In the Wild Kingdom section.
I wanted to congratulate
But you did all that already. Why? Why do this? Oh.
Oh my God!
I wanted to congratulate Lady Nair.
What the hell was that?
Yeah. Hold on. Do we have that? Hold on. Can we hear this again? What was this? Travis is gonna play it. What you just said,
Lady Nair. I want to congratulate.
Hold on, we'll have it in a second.
Oh my God.
You got it?
He's going to congratulate me when he comes up here.
Love.
He's not coming up. Right. This is your day, Lady Di.
Yeah, okay, thank you.
Travis has it.
All right, let's hear.
Why did they congratulate Lady Nair? What was that again?
I got to hear it.
Can we hear it again?
Hold on, you stop talking to the mic, Di.
Will everyone shut the fuck up for 1 second?
Lady Di's rambling into a microphone.
Yeah, she's trying to hear this clip.
I told Sam something.
All right, good.
Hold on. Right, I'm going to listen to this again.
All right,
go ahead, Di. I gave you guys a new ringtone.
Bobo, shut up. Travis, go ahead.
Go ahead, Di.
I wanted to congratulate Lee.
Stop talking. I know, but it's going out over that magic device.
You can't whisper in someone's ear when they're
I'm
on a mic.
Wear a girdle next time. How's that sound?
What's that?
A girdle.
Ugh.
You need a girdle?
Over your mouth.
Well, what do you think?
A girdle.
Of course you need a girdle.
The fuck
Colin. Is this?
The one that they used in the garbage thing in Star Wars?
No, not that one.
Colin.
Oh, for God's sake, no.
We got breaking news. We learned that Lady Di's pregnant today. She's 7 months
not
along.
I'm pregnant.
I keep hearing that, yeah.
Congratulations once again.
Thank you.
From the ONA community
Lady
to you.
I wanted to congratulate Lady Nair.
How about if you just call me Diana Natty Ice?
That is my favorite. Lady Nair.
And what was her awful one before?
What?
Oh, she said
buffler.
Water buffler.
I said that.
Oh my god, what, Bobo?
Are you gonna name the kid Natty Ice?
You said that 8 times to no laugh. How many fucking times are you gonna repeat it?
No comment.
What,
Bobo? Has anybody asked you why are you standing in our lobby?
Yeah. Why are you standing in the lobby? That's a very good question.
Has anybody downstairs, like security, asked you?
No, no one's asked me.
Why are you down there?
I wanted to say hi to you guys.
I wanted to congratulate Lady Nair.
And I wanted to be an intern.
Well, you can't.
What?
Lady Di is the intern.
Yeah, so you're just in the lobby, what, hoping we invite you up, I'm assuming, right?
Yeah.
Invite him up. Go ahead.
The hell is...
All right. Oh. Come on in. Yeah, we got plenty of room. Crowd's following out. Nice to see you in here.
Welcome
into Denny O's. Happy St. Patrick's Day to you. Especially you.
No.
He's pointing say hello to Way Back Dan.
Didn't even hear from Bobo.
Good to hear from him and Denny Fatbeard, who connected on Twitter this morning. Very nice.
Oh, he's giving shout-outs.
Is Bobo still there?
Denny O's Bar and Grill. Come on down. We've got room for you.
Hey, Bobo, are you in the bar right now?
I don't work blue, but today I'm working green.
What'd you say, Di?
The bar's not open right now.
It is in our imagination, Di.
Maybe 10 minutes, but not right now.
Good point. She looks like Jonathan Ross, the British TV host.
Oh, my God.
Who is that?
She kind of looks like fucking Jim Ross.
Yeah.
So, we have that Buffler clip. That made me so happy.
Well,
I just want to congratulate you on your baby. That's great. Is the father a water buffalo or an elephant?
The father is a water buffalo. Oh, my God. Yeah, that was me.
Water buffalo.
That's you, right? Who was that?
Buffalo.
Who was that?
Water buffalo.
Somebody on the phone.
But who was that talking to him?
Huh?
Who's that talking on the phone?
Oh, my God.
I have no idea who the person was.
No, it was you.
I don't know who the other person is.
Water
buffalo.
Now, can we hear the Bobo one again? I'm trying to figure out which one's better.
Lady Nair. Come on, Bobo, get my name straight.
Oh, boy.
Whoa.
All right.
Wow.
So Bobo's hanging out in the lobby. Lady Di's intern.
Uninvited, by the way.
And we have Colin Quinn to blame for this.
Right.
You have Colin to blame Quinn. Colin Quinn for this.
Well, it was kind of his
idea. Thank you, Lady Di.
It was kind of his idea.
I love you, Colin.
I love you, Diana.
Oh, yes. You don't Whoa. Have to blame him.
Yeah, but she wants to suck Anthony's dick, though. Yeah. We learned that today, Colin.
Good money to see that sex tape.
We did hear that.
And she wants to do 69 with Anthony.
Yeah. Yeah, that'll settle.
She's looking at Ant and bringing her eyebrows up and down.
Don't try to give me the lovey-dovey eyes.
Look at her, Ant. Ant.
Yeah.
Do it again, baby. Do it again.
Oh, she's blowing kisses over this way.
Sure, why not?
That's good.
She's just fun and flirty.
Yeah.
Did I always do that? Did I always blow kisses to you?
I'd like to fucking return some lead kisses.
I remember the first time I ever met you guys, I gave both of you a kiss on the cheek.
Oh.
You don't remember that, do you?
That's gross.
I don't remember that.
I want her to kiss someone's neck to see how that would be.
Not me. I got a girl.
It's Jim Norton.
Not happening.
I can't do
D-Rock.
It either.
You know,
Norton.
Denny is single right now.
Denny!
Wow!
Hey, Denny!
Denny Falcone.
I gave it up for Lent.
Oh.
Okay, well.
No, so I know.
Jim Norton's neck.
There's only one person left.
That ain't gonna happen.
It's so out of the realm of possibility.
Do it.
Die, go over there.
No, you sure?
No. It's so out of the realm of possibility.
Do you understand what you're missing?
Yeah,
yes, I do.
Hold on, I'm coming right over there.
No. Yeah. You will stay away.
I'm coming right over there.
She's coming over to you, Ant.
I will beat you with this.
Do it, Dan. No.
Get away!
Monster repellent. All right, she backed off.
Okay.
All right.
That's okay.
Bobo, anything else before we move on here?
Let him upstairs. You can't do that.
No.
Bobo.
Why not?
Yeah.
Anything else before we move on?
No, that's what I got.
All right.
You'll be there in the lobby, though, right?
Yeah. I'm going for the lobby.
All right.
In the lobby, why don't you walk right upstairs if you're that close?
Don't you mind your business?
My name's not in the system.
Oh, that's weird.
Huh.
All right, Bubba, thank you. Colin, anything else?
Upstairs.
Good luck.
Yeah, how could it not? Call. It's all the recipes for an amazing Monday.
See you later, Bobo.
All the ingredients are here.
Yes.
Why don't you let him upstairs?
And a happy St. Patrick's Day to you. Thank you for coming down today. Hello to Colleen, Doreen, Maureen, Jolene. But come on, Eileen, as we bring it back in time to the big 80s. It's Dexy's Midnight Runners from the Opie and Anthony and Irish Extravaganza.
Oh, you guys sing along?
Happy St. Patrick's Day. Let's all sing along with Dexy's.
Lady Di.
Come on, Eileen.
Sing along to this, Lady Di, right?
What is it?
You know.
Come on, Eileen.
Aunt, would you?
Not even.
No?
No. Wait for the big part. Sam Song beads at her. Mardi Gras beads at her. In that dress, I can't wait till she starts to take it. Yeah. It's going to be great when she starts.
All right, Lady Di, take your headphones off. We're going to break.
Yeah.
Very funny.
You did it.
I know I did it.
She's all tangled with the beads and the headphones. All right, we'll be back.
What's up, baby? You want to get some dirty talk going? Yeah, that's it. I'm going to give some cyber sex. I'm good. I'm going to lay you back or something. And I'm going to lick all the way down your neck like this. I'm going to take my tongue and just go like... I'm going to clean out your ears or something and get wax on my tongue and then lick all the way down your neck. Oh, that's a nice dark nipple. I wouldn't mind getting some milk out of that. And then I'm going to get my tongue and I'm going to start flicking it all over your nipples so much that you start coming. You're going to come so much that your shoes are going to make sloshy noises. And I'm going to get down there and just start licking your fucking cooter really good. I'll open up your cooter. I got like long nails on my middle fingers. So I'll dig my nails into your cooter lips and I'll open them up and I'll just go like, and I'll get in there until you come so many times or whatever. I'll stick it right in you too. I'll climb right up on you like you're a building or something. I'm gonna climb on like you're a tree or something and just cram my oats in you. Someone put a finger in my ass.
Clean the bowl with your sock. Opie and Anthony are back.
All right, we got the connection back here. Tell those guys in the satellite truck to wake up. Put down the Bass Ale. Yeah, we're back here on the Opie and Anthony St. Patrick's Day extravaganza. It's Denny O down at the Bar and Grill, and we've got the Irish tunes playing for you today. Get you into the spirit of the holiday where everybody is Irish today. How about Flogging Molly by request? And a little Salty Dog for you today.
Thanks, Danny. Yeah, St. Patrick's Day here in New York City. Parade Day.
Yes.
There's nothing new on the Malaysian situation. So. But you just said what? The co-pilot said goodnight?
Yeah, they said they're saying that the co-pilot said... all right, good night.
And that's not protocol? Should be the pilot, or?
No, it's just, it seems odd that that was said after the electronics were turned off.
All right.
Because everybody is assuming that it was the pilot, if it is indeed a suicide thing, that it was the pilot that did it.
Yeah, they keep showing him, because he had the flight simulators and stuff, but he just loved to fly.
But saying maybe the co-pilot... was the one, but who the fuck knows at this point?
Yeah, he's no. Qualified to fly a 777.
But why are people going, oh, he has the flight simulator because he loves to fly. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That'd be a way around a few things to say, no, man, I got this in my house because I just love to fly.
I love to fly.
I want
to
try one of those.
As you have a little side business going on.
Yeah.
In between flights.
That'd be
fun.
Who
knows? That would be fun, right?
A little flight simulator.
I'm thinking around. Middle of the Indian Ocean. Suicide.
Yeah.
Some kind of suicide. Yeah.
Could be.
In other news, David Brenner. He was a staple of The Tonight Show.
Yeah.
A very funny comic. Did you like him, Jimmy?
I did, yeah. And I met him once, I think, in the lobby or once or twice. He's really nice.
He was 78. He died over the weekend.
78.
And,
what'd he have?
Cancer.
Yeah, he had the cancer. And there's another very famous person that has the cancer.
Uh-oh. Who's that?
Well, this clip might give it away. Oh. Might have a clip that gives it away.
Clip?
Yeah.
Jeez.
Maybe.
18 years ago, I left Dayton, Ohio.
Oh, no.
With two very bad knees. And a dream to become a Major League Baseball player.
Oh, boy.
I thank God this dream came true.
Oh, man.
I think he used his one God thing for the wrong situation.
Does he have...
Stage 3, right?
Stage 3 skin cancer.
Oh, boy.
That's a rough one.
Yes.
Skin cancer is a rough one. But also one that he could take care of early on.
Gee.
Get your skin checked, people.
Man.
Tom Chiasano sent me down that road a few years back. Because he had, I think Tom Chiasano had like stage four. He was like, he was on the way out and made a, just an amazing recovery from the whole thing.
Yeah.
And man, that got me going to the doctor. I get crap burned off me all the time now. That pre shit before it becomes something.
I gotta go to your lady. I keep forgetting to do that.
Yeah, she's cool. She'll lift up your ball bag and everything too.
I want to see if I got any roids too. Do I got my regular doctor for that?
You should just go while I'm here. Could you check if I have roids?
Yeah.
Oh, she's got to check everything.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's beautiful too. You lay there naked with your robe on, and all of a sudden the conversation stops because she undoes your robe and you're just completely nude.
I'll take a nice Viagra.
I like Dr. Van Nostrand. I go to him for all of my needs, my skin needs.
So he's like giving you the full body check?
Yeah. And he can take a little section if he needs.
Does he lift up the ball bag?
Sure.
Yeah, sure. With his nose.
Oh. Lift it right up.
Seinfeld. Fuck! Damn it! I should have known that one.
Yeah, why would Anthony give his real doctor?
Jesus.
He uses a meat slicer. It's amazing.
Yeah. I did tell the story where I went over there with swampy ass though. And I was so embarrassed.
Dude, how do you go to the doctor with swamp ass?
It was a nice day and I had this appointment. I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna walk. Oh man, was I a sweaty mess by the time I got in that doctor's office.
Holy
shit. I have no doubt it did. You just know when it's not good.
Did you have to look by your ass?
A little squishy in the back. Yes, I had a turnover and everything.
You embarrassed?
Yes, because she's like, she's in her 40s. She's her number's way up there, man.
Jesus, she must have smelled like ass.
I was so embarrassed. I did do a quick wipe in her bathroom, but
that won't stop.
I don't think it took care of all the issues at hand. You should go to her.
Scrub that shit.
Yeah.
Scrub that shit out.
Anyway. So, David Brenner, you got Mike Schmidt with the stage 3 skin cancer.
Man.
Paul McCartney's divorce was final 6 years ago.
To Heather Mills.
He only paid $48.6 million.
For 2 years?
Well, she wrote...
she wrote yesterday.
Yesterday?
So.
Is that what she wrote?
So I think that's fair, right?
Unbelievable.
$48 million to that fucking pig.
Just because he was fucking her.
How is that fair? She didn't write that shit.
It's disgusting.
Bitches.
For 2 years.
That's all it was, 2 years.
Or 3 years, whatever. You know what I mean?
I understand taking care of the ladies, but not to that.
Almost $50
million. $50 million for what?
That's crazy.
Because of the lifestyle she was accustomed to all of a sudden? Is that what it is?
Yeah, come suck your husband's dick. He's used to it.
Right.
Yeah, yeah.
For as long as you collect alimony, you should have to suck and fuck your husband whenever he wants.
God, that's just robbery.
Yeah, of course it is.
And assault and battery?
No, I think just robbery.
Robbery.
Yeah.
Assault and battery. Wait, how does that go? Robbery, assault and battery.
Huh?
It's an old Genesis song.
Really?
Robbery, assault and battery. I don't know. Whatever.
I'm trying to think what song that was.
Also, the Golden Gate Bridge. They've had it with people jumping.
Oh, yeah? What are they going
to
do?
They're going to try to set up some nets.
Really?
They didn't want to take away from the beauty of the bridge. That's why they didn't do what they do with all the bridges here in New York, where you can't see over the sides and stuff when you're driving across. Although the GWB is pretty creepy. I've taken a bike across that a few times, and man, those railings are barely above your waist.
So if you, like, weaved with your bike and hit the railing, you could literally fly over the edge and...
I would say so. I would say that's definitely a possibility.
Jeez.
Yeah, the GWB is a bit creepy. But most of the other bridges, they make sure you can't really get over the side.
Yo. We walked over, me and Kenny, when we were out in San Francisco, and you could see the... It's scary because I'm afraid of heights, and there's some places where it's easy to jump.
And that railing is pretty low.
It's you won't fall off it, but you could get over it and jump.
Right.
So what are they going to do? Like,
and the Golden Gate Bridge, I walked across as well. It's creepy because the cars come flying by you. There's not a lot of room.
Right.
But then they have these alcoves, wherever you want to call it.
Yeah.
So you could go in a little bit away from the traffic. But when you're walking back off that bridge, these cars are flying by your ear.
Really?
Yeah, it's...
scary.
I think it's a little scary. I don't know. It might be a pussy, though.
Nah.
No, it's... And then you got the Playboy model. Did you see the golf shot yet?
Yes,
golf
I watched shot. It.
You didn't see this yet, Ann?
No, what is it?
Yeah. Wow.
It's a, man. It's a half a million dollar injury, sure.
Do you mind if I turn down your fake bar for a minute?
Hey, guys in the truck, could you lower the microphones?
No, that's not. No, I did that. We're not in a bar.
It's a guy in the truck.
Yeah, guy in the truck.
We're in our studio.
Oh, my God.
Is that one of the most amazing bruises you've ever seen
in
your life?
Oh, my God.
Oh, wow, he really.
Go to TMZ if you haven't seen this yet. But
what the fuck happened?
I banged my big dick on it.
Nice.
And I swear to you, this is something that we could easily have done.
Yeah.
That's right. Basically, you got some kind of gig going on. And
crazy radio guys?
Playboy Radio, yeah. A comedian. Yeah,
on our platform.
Oh, this happened on SiriusXM?
Yeah.
No kidding,
you
really?
You can see the SiriusXM mic flags in the video.
Oh.
So now no more golfing out of an asshole.
Oh, right. Boy.
So they decide, look, let's put a T.
But with one. Rich.
Let's put a ball on a tee and have the tee coming from her butt.
From her butt.
And look, I know what I'm doing, so I'm going to like take a driver and hit the ball off your butt, basically.
Well, I hope this guy knows he's on his own.
Wow.
That's the way they do it.
And
so right now, she's on her stomach, and her fat ass is hanging out really nice. And he's got the golf on the tee.
Nice rump.
And he's going to hit the
mic in the ball.
Full swing. He really smashed her fat
up. Oh, wow.
He hit...
And she's trying to laugh it off.
She's trying to be cool.
Wow, did he fucking...
I think you're going to need some ice.
I just crushed her butt so hard.
I didn't even know that was SiriusXM.
Yeah, boy. That's the logo.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, and he's trying to play it off. He's like, oh, I'm
so
in
you know when you tee off and your driver kind of skims the grass
right.
before it actually hits the ball? That's what it kind of did to her ass.
Oh, yeah.
That's a great ass.
He didn't directly connect like bam, like a divot.
No.
You have a little welt.
A little welt.
A little welt.
Well, after a second, it probably
had a
sure.
subdural hematoma.
Yeah.
And then they got a picture on TMZ of the butt the next day or something, and it is an amazing.
That's in the brain, right?
He hit her with a golf club, Sam.
Oh, shit.
The girl bled internally.
Wow. It's her whole cheek is black and blue.
Imagine licking that.
Could kiss it all better.
Mm.
Yeah, you gotta help. You gotta help that out.
Do that. You know.
So.
Okay, we're back. What? We're back at Denny O's. I tell you, this party is just getting out of hand. Everybody's getting their green on. What's that? Oh. You want to jump around? Bring in the House of Pain to liven up the festivities. Happy St. Patrick Day from Denny O's.
Patrick's Day.
St. Patrick's Day.
St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah.
They're saying that golf shot happened in 2012?
Yeah, it was a year ago.
Yeah, but she's suing for $500,000. Because that's a half a million dollar injury.
Wow. Half a mil.
I don't know. I mean... I don't blame her.
For half a million?
Look at her ass. She makes a lot of money off that
I'm
ass.
I'm sure it's fine now.
Yeah, I'd like to see the contract.
She probably bruises easily.
Yeah.
I mean, I understand she's got, you know.
Yeah.
But that guy, I hope this guy has insurance.
Hey, you people over there. You want to, what?
Hey, what? Come on, get down off the bar.
Get down.
Yeah,
you're going to slip on the beer.
I loved it. I love Denny's bar. Is this a traditional Irish song?
I believe so, yes.
Oh, yeah.
Every St. Patrick's Day, I look forward to this one.
Oh, yeah.
What happened to the traditional St. Patrick's Day music?
We're just mixing it up today.
Oh, you are.
What a great variety of the best of yesterday and today.
You're mixing it up?
Get that.
By the way, because people, I guess, are just tuning in, yes, we all know that Mayor Menino is diagnosed with advanced form of cancer. We're not touching that one. We're not touching this.
Yeah. No.
It's horrible news for him and his family, period. That's all you're going to get from me.
Yeah, the guy, obviously, we've goofed on him.
Many
over the
years,
years
ago, 16 years ago.
And just his speech and everything. We've goofed on that.
I have no problem that we did all that. But
what does that mean? We're supposed to fucking bask in someone's misfortunes?
Hell no. And you know, looking back with perspective, I don't even really feel good about the initial prank we did back in the day.
Yeah,
but we did it, and that's it.
Way back in what we call the day, I guess.
Can't be helped.
Yeah.
And you heard about...
There's nothing we could do about it.
You heard about the scrotum guy that we had on our show.
Yes.
Wesley Warren.
He looked so healthy.
He was kind of cool. He was the man with the 132-pound scrotum. They did a whole show on him on TLC, wasn't it?
I wouldn't shake his hand because he was fucking touching his big balls and his dick. And
he died at the age of 49.
What did he die of, actually?
I don't know.
He had heart attacks.
Died at the age of 103.
He was in the hospital for heart attacks. So... Lady Di is reportedly going through withdrawal symptoms right now. What do you mean?
Well, I just got told she's now in the office claiming exhaustion. She's all red in the face. She's teary-eyed. She's asking other interns to get her coffee.
Can you get her in here real fast?
She's probably just tired.
She's got the gags.
She's probably getting a hangover.
A
hangover is kicking in.
I think she's at the point where she needs alcohol.
She needs this natty ice.
I hope the poor deer is okay.
She's a fucking disaster, this one.
Oh, my God.
You're a goddamn disgrace!
By the way, her internship is a fake, and she came here on her own.
Yeah, yeah. Fuck. Right?
Oh, my God. What do you mean? She's a paid intern?
No.
She's a part of the crew.
No. What do you got, Eric? Got an update on her?
Bring him in. Well, as I was walking up, they were running down to get Bobo or whatever.
Why?
And Lady Di's sitting there rubbing her eyes,
what
like tearing.
What do you mean,
they're
getting Bobo?
I think he's downstairs, right?
So what?
Oh, no. Here comes Lady Di.
She's rubbing her eyes, and I go, what's the matter? And she goes, well, I'm really tired. You know, I got up very early this morning.
All right.
Oh, boy.
So
one day.
She was crouched over on Denny's desk.
Oh,
there.
Look at her. We're all tired.
Yeah.
Lady Di, like, you all right?
Thanks. Hello, dear.
Yeah, I'm all right.
What's
I'm
the matter,
right?
Lady Di?
Wow, you really don't look good. You all right?
You hit the wall. You're a little tired.
I'm just a little tired. That's all.
Sam.
I got up too early.
E-Rock gave away the other bit. He said Bobo's coming up.
I'm not going through withdrawal systems. I see what you're
putting down.
Yeah. No, I'm just tired, that's all.
Remember that guy on...
Blathered it out.
He just goes and just says it?
Yeah, he goes, oh yeah, they're on their way bringing Bobo up.
It was going to be
Bobo was up here already.
Kind of came up with, and...
Remember Return of the...
just gives away the reveal.
He just, why not?
Remember Return of the King? Return of the King?
Yeah.
Remember that one?
Smell the fear. The air is rank with it.
That's you, from Lord of the Rings.
Oh, yeah?
He was a villain, though.
A little bit. He was a bad guy.
Well, I never saw that movie.
He was a bad guy.
Like, you zooted.
I never saw that movie.
But what happened to you? You had energy and stuff. A mere half
hour. I still got energy, but
you were running around
like
crazy.
I'm starting to feel tired because...
She said a little headachey, too.
They're saying you're suffering from exhaustion. You got teary eyes, which I noticed earlier. You're gagging and you're out of breath.
I'm gagging because I'm nervous.
Are you staying hydrated? Are you drinking water?
Yeah.
No,
you
got to
drink water.
I haven't had any water.
What's wrong with you? Since when?
It's warm.
Go ahead. What are you guys?
All right. Okay.
You've never had a bottle of water, have you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Oh my God.
Down the hatch, all the way down.
Like
I can't do that.
Wow. Right. She even drinks water, sexy.
Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
She is sexy.
You're so sexy.
You wouldn't make out with her?
That is so sweet.
No, I need a relationship before I.
Really?
Yes.
No. I could do that.
Really?
Yeah.
Really. Lady Di.
It's interesting, the sexual energy that she exudes when she comes
I was just wondering about something. Is there any way you could give me a train pass for the rest of the week? No, seriously.
The set of
no.
On this one.
I think that's fair.
Look at the buttons.
Yeah. I think it's
give
fair.
You a train pass like that ex-husband of yours.
Oh,
how about that?
Wow.
He's jealous of the ex-husband.
Nice.
He's jealous.
Nah.
He's the one that put himself in front of the train.
No, I know.
You do?
He thought that was a new stop.
Why do you keep on bringing that up?
Yeah, it's
I know. I don't want this. Lady Di, I got to ask you a very serious question. You're obviously an alcoholic.
Oh,
fair enough.
Shit.
I admit it to drinking, yeah.
Do you need a beer right now?
No.
Are you going through some kind of withdrawals?
Not right now. I'm going to have one later when I watch the parade, maybe. Something like that.
After you punch out.
Okay. All right.
Yeah.
Oh, look at that. There's the camera.
Yeah.
There's the Fox News cam down there on the street. Where's Bobo?
I'm sure whenever she does have a beer, man. E-Rock
Bobo's
will just,
right here.
Oh.
What?
E-Rock will probably just run in and let us know when she has.
Bobo's down the wall.
Hold on, where's E-Rock?
Down the hall, too.
All right, can we bring stupid E-Rock in for a second?
Hey, Di, could you grab E-Rock? You're an intern.
Okay, I'll be right back.
Yeah, tell him in here.
All right. Okay.
Bring Piggy Boy.
Roland is our guest here.
Look at those pants.
Is he here yet or no?
We got Pedro Pascal coming in today.
He's a man.
Yeah. I don't think he's here just yet.
He's the new villain on Game of Thrones, and it was fucking good. Did you see Travis?
It was so good.
I see
the bit that E-Rock wasn't involved with, and we were going to get Bobo up here, and we were going to go, like, how did Bobo get up here? And then it turns out Lady Di put him in the system.
Oh. Okay.
You weren't in on the Bobo bit?
No.
What? There was a whole bit.
We wanted you to come in because someone said that. What kind of deodorant are you wearing?
What kind of deodorant? All right, Irish Spring soap.
Okay, so
not deodorant.
We wanted you to.
That's a soap.
The guys wanted you to check her underarms and see if they were raw.
No,
that was punishment for the Bobo reveal.
Yeah, right. You messed up the Bobo reveal.
Is that part of the intern job?
Lift up your arm.
There's two spots I want him to smell. Is that cool?
Yeah, so he won't touch you.
Underarms and under boobs.
Before I do this,
under bubs.
Oh, you want to see my boobs again?
But no, I want E-Rock to smell under there. I don't have to touch anything. E-Rock.
Here, let me shut the curtain. Lift so you just take your shirt off.
Before I do this, I'm coming up the hallway. And she goes, all right, are you E-Rock? She's been talking to me all morning. She's like, are you E-Rock? Yes.
They want you
in the studio. And she's like showing me where the studio is.
How do you not know that that's E-Rock?
Exactly.
I don't know.
Maybe he wasn't making a mistake.
Sorry. All right, lift your shirt up.
Now, what?
All the way up.
All the way up?
Yeah, you're pregnant. Congratulations on that.
She looks good.
Yeah, you look all right.
I am not pregnant.
Hold on, E-Rock's trying to get in there. Lift it up again.
Lift it up again, dear.
E-Rock's going to smell too.
What?
So you're sweating. You're sweating under your boobs. Under your boobs. Look. Lift up.
No. We're doing the underarms first.
Come on, E-Rock. Get in there. E-Rock. What are you doing? Killing my heart on.
All right, lean.
It's probably not.
Wait, Lady Di, lean more toward the mic.
It might not be bad. Here. I was just curious. It might not be bad at all.
All right, here we go.
She's got red stains on her bra.
Hold on.
No,
I got red stains on my bra.
Hold on, just in case.
Hold on.
E-Rock's going to attempt to. All right, hold on.
All right, go ahead.
Hold on. Go.
Not bad, right?
It's not that bad. The rest of her stinks worse than that.
Under the bra. It
smells like death and cigarettes.
Under the bra. Come on. Now.
Under the old bra. What's going on
there?
What?
Looks like...
Get in there.
What's going on?
Just get in there.
Watch
out. Lift it up. There you go. Smell.
No, I'm not going to lift up.
A little bit. Yeah, you don't show the bubs. Go ahead. You're not getting
bubs.
Oof.
Is that a little...
a little gamey?
That's... Yo. That is sweat and grime.
Right.
You're embarrassing her. What's wrong with you?
And alcohol.
She's got BO under her boobs.
A little buzz on the boobs.
I didn't have anything to drink today.
Exactly.
You did at 2 a.m. You said you had some natties.
I had a couple, you know, on the mic.
Uh-huh. Had some natties.
Yeah.
I had two natties at 2 a.m. Yes, I did.
She's shaking like fucking Hitler in that movie.
put your arm out like this.
Every movie he shakes.
You're not shaking too bad.
I'm not shaking at all.
Downfall.
I just feel tired because I got up too early this morning.
Right.
And then I couldn't go back
to
sleep.
Right, we heard you.
Well, we all did.
That's what happens.
Yeah, exactly.
We all got up early.
Yeah.
We got to take a break because Danny should take us to break, huh?
Right. Hey.
We got Pedro Pascal coming in studio in a few minutes.
Pedro Pascal.
Do you know who he is?
No. I heard it's a show on HBO.
What show?
What show was that again?
You put the BO in HBO.
What show was that again?
Right.
What?
Hey. Game of Thrones.
Hey.
Game of Thrones.
Okay, Game of Thrones. I don't have HBO.
All right, we're going to talk to him next, though.
Okay.
All right, but first, Danny, take us out for a minute.
Hey, welcome back to Denny O's. Just want to remind you that today we have St. Paddy's Day Radio that's going on all day on Sirius XM Channel 28. So if you just want to hear more and more of this great St. Patrick's Day music, you check that out, Sirius XM 28. Let's bring in the Pogues and the Dubliners.
Dubliners?
On the 4th of July, 806, we set sail from the street called the car. We were sailing away with a cargo of bricks for the Grand City Hall in New York. But a wonderful craft, she was rigged for the dock. And now how the wild wind over, she stood several blasts. She had 27 masts, and they called her the Irish Rover.
Leave your penis alone. The Opie and Anthony Show is back on.
Hey guys!
guys in a truck. Come on, wake up. We're doing a live show today. Back here at Denny O's. Opie and Anthony show. Happy St. Patrick's Day to you. We hope everybody's having themselves a great time today.
All right, thanks for that.
Sit over there.
Jesus. How do you not take hints?
We're a little worried about Lady Di. She's exhausted.
She is acting exhausted, yes.
I think she's going through withdrawals. Maybe we should get Dr. Steve on the phone after the interview with Pedro. Have Dr. Steve on standby, Sam, please.
Yeah.
From Game of Thrones, we got Pedro Pascal coming into the studio. You going to sit there? You got a question for Pedro, hopefully?
Yeah, you can help out.
One question?
Die. Take your beverages.
The water.
Here comes Pedro now.
There he is.
Wow, there he is.
He's
right.
Sir, come on, take a seat.
Wow, Game of Thrones.
Don't mind.
Pedro Pascal in studio. Welcome, sir.
I keep on forgetting it's St. Patrick's Day.
Oh, yeah.
Green.
Yeah, yeah, St. Patrick's Day.
Yeah.
It should make driving around Manhattan very, very...
super easy.
Yeah, very easy today.
The city gets crazy today, man.
I'm wearing green, and then I'll just be really drunk, and they'll let me...
Yeah. That, or then you got carte blanche. You go wherever you want.
Exactly.
As long as you're drinking.
How drunk are you? Oh, you're really drunk. Come on through.
Yeah.
What a lousy day to do press, though, as far as getting around the city, because the whole middle of the city is going to be shut down.
Pain in the ass.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Fifth Avenue.
Yeah.
Where else are you going?
We're going over to the third. We're supposed to be going over to Third Avenue in a little bit.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah, it's perfect. That's what's next.
Perfect.
Yeah, you'd be on the subway, I guess.
Well, not many that go that way, though, is the problem. Not many east west subways.
No,
there aren't.
Not really.
So we're fucked.
You're pretty much fucked there. Yeah. You get recognized out there?
No, because it hasn't aired yet.
I know, yeah. I just figured, you know.
So I'm totally
we saw
anonymous.
It, though.
Some people that.
So, and then if you saw me, if you saw me walking down the street, would you recognize me from what you saw? No, right? Because I'm like all like in like a robe and like dark hair. And
that is true. Yeah, yeah.
I might be able to get away with
it. What about other stuff, though, that you've done?
Yeah, sometimes.
Yeah.
You know, every once in a while. I mean, it's been pretty kind of anonymous stuff up to now. Like,
yeah.
I've been in New York for so many years, and like we all do like the Law and Orders and stuff like
that. Right,
right,
yeah,
know?
Yeah.
And been doing some more things in L.A., but I don't know, I kind of look really different from each thing. I get recognized every once in a while.
Yeah, yeah.
Not like other friends of mine that I hang out with. I've got some really good friends on American Horror Story, and that shit is crazy. And then, of course, hanging out with people from Game of Thrones.
Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
Hard for Peter Dinklage to get around, right?
Well, yeah, exactly.
That's for sure, man. Well, I'm sure after it airs and stuff.
Yeah.
And you're going to be like one of those guys now. That must have been some nice call from the old agent.
I know,
hey,
right?
You know, there's a little show.
Yeah.
You may have heard of it.
I don't know if you're
there's this little show on a little network.
Right. Little network.
Called
Game of Thrones.
HQ.
You might have heard about it.
Yeah.
So that had to be pretty goddamn exciting to
it was really,
score that gig.
Yeah, it was really, yeah. It was
totally were you a fan
exciting.
Of the show?
I was a total fan of the show. Yeah, I was watching it like a proper fan. I was even like all caught up when the audition came around. Like I binged on the first two seasons and then I had to wait for the third season to come out. And so it was like DVRing it every Sunday.
Yeah.
And then it came around. And to be honest with you, I was like, I'll never get this.
There's no way.
Yeah. You know what I mean? And there was a lot of material to learn for the audition that was full of spoilers. It ruined the fourth season. So I was like, I'm never going to get this job, and the fourth season is fucking ruined. And I'm not kidding. I like threw the pages in the air. I was like, oh my God, this happened. Like, there was this one particular thing that I had been waiting three seasons, you know, like wondering how it was going to go down.
Right.
And now I knew, like, in a second, by reading it on a piece of paper.
As a fan, that's fucked.
Yeah.
That's pretty funny.
It was pretty terrible because, like, they shoot in Europe. Oh, no. Go ahead.
What other shows were you on? Because I don't get HBO.
You don't get HBO?
No,
what
I don't.
She do? Well, what shows do you watch? What do you
I watch basic cable.
Uh-huh. Like, do you watch, like, USA?
Huh?
Do you watch USA Network?
Sometimes.
Did you ever see that show Graceland? FBI undercover show, a bunch of hot people living in a house in Malibu.
Right, yeah, no, I never saw that.
Well, I did that.
Okay.
Sorry.
Lady Di, why would you ask that question?
At that moment.
No, at that moment.
What other shows
we had a nice like roll going with this guy.
I know, that was totally, that was going to be my best story, by the way. Like, you're not going to get anything better than that. I was on a roll there.
I love that angle that you're a fan and you read what a major plot point and thinking, oh, man, I'm one of 1,000 people here today. I'm going home and now the show's ruined for me.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And then you have to. I'll see you on television.
Hopefully someday.
Hopefully.
just channel surf. Don't like, you know all of your watches? Basic cable channels, and you'll probably catch me.
She watches watch the Partridge Family and the Monkees.
Oh, I love the Monkees.
I didn't do an episode of the Monkees.
You're not going to see them on the Monkees.
They just had a convention.
But we're talking to the guy from Game of Thrones.
Yes, it's the new, I don't want to say you're the new villain. You're the kind of the new, enemy of the Lannisters. Yeah, I wouldn't say villain.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. He's not a villain. Everyone's like, are you a bad guy? And I say, I don't think so.
Maybe to the Lannisters.
Yeah, to the Lannisters. But then if you're a bad guy to the Lannisters,
does
you're
that
probably
you a bad
kind
guy?
Of a good guy to
right.
most people.
Exactly. Mm-hmm.
But that's what's cool about the show, because as soon as you feel a certain way about a certain character, then they flip it and they're like, actually, they're kind of cool. Or, or this person you love is actually a total douche.
Where is that filmed?
We shot in Ireland.
It is over there.
And in Croatia, and they also shoot in Iceland.
Croatia.
How cool is that?
So these really, really shitty locations.
Snow.
Right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. All the snowy stuff is Iceland. All of the interior. Well, should I break it down for everybody?
Yeah, I'm curious.
You know, the green stuff.
Right, all the green stuff.
Trees and green and stuff like that is Ireland, snow, Iceland, and the glistening, beautiful Adriatic Sea would be Croatia. Wow. They were in Morocco in the third season, so they were in four locations last year.
How's Iceland?
I did
when
not,
you're not shooting.
I did not
oh,
go to,
oh,
I didn't
have
go to,
go to the, yeah.
But oh, so he's not going to be in the snowy scene.
That's part of the map.
Poor me.
Yeah,
I got all the really shitty locations. And that was another part of, like, the it being sort of incomprehensible, like, early on, like, that I would get it. Because it's just this show, like, you watch and you never, as an actor, you think, oh, you know, ooh, I hope I get an audition for Mad Men. I know that casting director. You know what I mean? Or like The Killing, they shoot that in Vancouver, but they cast it here. How exciting. Oh, yeah. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
With this, it was just like there was no association whatsoever. You know what
Damn.
I mean? And
you
it was all a bunch of European
away.
Actors. Well, all I meant to say was that it just didn't expect it to happen. So I was really just like, you know, ruin the fourth season for me. And that's basically, that's what I'm getting out of this.
Instead,
I got a job.
I got the gig.
Good for you. Congratulations.
How many rounds do you have to go through?
Well, because they cast out of London, they asked me to put myself on tape, which I did with my iPhone.
Wow.
You got this, you got Game of Thrones off your iPhone?
That was step one. I got past the first step with my iPhone.
But what are they?
Where the hell else am I going to tape it with? That's what you're going to tape with.
But what do they make you do with the iPhone? Certain lines or?
Yeah. Like,
they give you the lines and
it was like 17
Did you do it like
pages.
A selfie or did you have someone at least hold a camera?
I had a friend literally like prop up my iPhone with his left hand, elbow on the table and like turn the pages with his right and read it with me.
Wow.
Yeah,
but that's how it's done now, guys.
Yeah.
It is. But I actually went
it's
in
a whole
for,
new world.
I went in recently and I was lousy, and I was like, "God damn it! I wish I would have sent myself on tape because I could have redone that." I was so mad at myself. That is the way everybody does it now.
Yeah.
It seems like you would have a better chance if you're taping yourself.
Because you can do it a few times, right?
Kind of do it a few times.
No one will see the bad ones, right?
Yeah. You can get you, and you can also get yourself stuck in a vortex of like doing it over and
over
and never happy with it.
That's one part I got to do it over again.
Yeah. So I treat it like as if there's almost a casting director there, where I'm like. Okay, just two shots. I'm not going to look at it. Just send it in.
Mm. Should do the whole thing where you like green screen it behind you.
Special effects.
In costume.
Yeah, exactly. I could score it with music.
Right.
People do that.
Score it.
What I should have done, in the background, I could have had. Dun, 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 dun.
When does it air?
It airs April 6th, the first episode.
Because I saw the first one. They gave us HBO. What channel could it be?
Remember the part where you don't have HBO?
Yeah.
I just have basic cable. That's all
I
got.
We know about your basic cable.
It would help the interview the first time. It really banged it home the second time.
What channel? My best friend Marion, she has HBO.
Who cares? He doesn't know who Marion is. Why don't you tell him that? Who gives a shit?
Well, why don't you go over to Marion's house?
Yes.
Marianne or Mary? Mary? Mary's house?
Marion.
Marion. Go to Marion's house and watch some HBO.
You're mad at him because he doesn't understand Marion's name, and yet he didn't yell at you for not knowing HBO after nine times of reiterating it.
I'm not
you
mad
said
at
April
you.
6th?
April 6th. Go to Marion's house on April 6th.
You might recognize her from Game of Thrones. She plays one of Khaleesi's dragons.
Get on before.
I'm with this Tuesday.
You really should watch Game of Thrones, Lady Di.
It's
Game
good.
Of Thrones. That's the name of the show? Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
I don't know. All right. Okay.
It's only been like one of the hit shows of the past few years. And yeah. It's,
but I don't
it's easily in the top
HBO.
Five of all shows that have come out in the last 5 years.
Even people...
No, but listen, I'm not mad at you. I'm not mad at you, baby. You're pissing them off, not me.
No, we're not mad at you. She's our intern today, so thanks for bearing with her.
I think I'm doing a good job.
At least you
so
get to
far.
Leave.
Oh, yeah.
Aside from the fact that I'm tired.
Hey, what did they do about your tattoos, by the way? You get like a little tattoo. They left them or they cover them up?
They cover them up.
Mm.
Yeah, they cover them up. I think in some instances they might have... A shot or two, they might have to like CGI or something.
Oh, green screen.
Digitally removed.
You know, it is a digitally removed.
Yeah.
It's not TV, it is HBO.
Right.
You play a very dirty boy, too. He's a great fucking. Very naughty boy.
naughty.
A rather dirty boy with some sexual proclivities.
Yeah. It's an interesting way the character is sort of introduced,
how was that?
Isn't it? It's kind of like different than your average character, new character.
And it's oddly like, acceptable on that show for some reason. It just works.
Yeah.
Do you ever feel uncomfortable when... Lady Di, what's going on?
What's the matter, Lady
My
Di?
Coffee is hot.
Is that my water?
No, you don't want to drink
water.
That.
That's your water?
That's brand new.
Can you believe?
As an actor, though, do you ever get in situations where you're uncomfortable with the scene you got to shoot?
I guess on this one, I was kind of like learning what makes me nervous and what doesn't. The dirty stuff didn't make me that nervous.
No, okay. Huh?
Yeah, the dirty stuff was like, whatever,
yeah.
You know? I'm not terribly experienced, but it was different stuff. It was more like doing like a scene with Charles Dance that scared the shit out of me.
Yeah.
Right.
Or like, you know, learning how to like helicopter a spear around while I'm in like a really like tightly fitted leather armor, you know?
And look
that
cool
kind of
doing
shit.
It.
And look, yeah, and look
trying
like
to look
a
cool.
Badass.
Yeah. Yeah.
That was a little crippling to my ego, but... But that stuff was fun.
I don't know.
No shit.
I don't know how actors do the nude scenes. I just don't. I don't understand.
It's
like you're nervous and ready to act, and now you got to do it completely in the nude.
It's a lot easier than you'd think.
On Girls last night, Lena Dunham is completely nude, getting just railed. It's the opening scene. Just everyone is completely naked, and then the guy finishes, and then he just yanks his rubber off and throws it in the wastebasket. I'm like, how do you do that as an actor? You know what I mean?
She's always naked.
No, she's comfortable with it. I get it. But then this guy that, you know, was in the scene with her, I don't understand how you guys could be comfortable.
I mean, I haven't done anything like that.
No, not to that extent.
And she's made it kind of like a signature thing to
her
have,
thing.
You know, like inhibitions around,
right.
know, revealing herself and just sort of expressing herself in this way.
But she's a rarity.
She's a complete rarity. I think for some people, it's a lot scarier than it is for others. For me, it's not as scary. Granted, I haven't had to do much. Like, I've done a lot of theater, you know, in life, and I've had to get naked on stage, which I thought was just going to be terrifying.
Hair or old Calcutta? What were you at?
Exactly. The Caligula scene. And it was a lot less scary than I expected it to
full
be.
Frontal?
Yeah.
You did full frontal on a stage?
Yeah.
Did that doesn't bother you?
It's kind of like obnoxious, but I always find like nudity on stage to be a little, I don't know, just a little irritating because it's a little distracting. I thought it was going to be scary as shit, but it wasn't. It just wasn't. And I can't tell you why. I didn't feel empowered. I didn't feel free.
Right.
I was just like, well, this is happening.
And
we're
all guys here, right, Lady Di? Jimmy had a good question in there.
Oh my God!
Jimmy had a good question there. Like if that was me,
we're all guys here. Go along with them, you know.
Lady Di, why do you let them do this to
Pedro?
You?
Exactly.
What? Why do you let them treat you this way?
It's all right. I don't care.
Jimmy had a good question there that went by everyone's head, though. As guys, you have to like fluff up a little, right?
That's the crazy thing. I wonder about like the people that do it more on a regular basis and if they have it figured out, because for me it's like I don't know, how hydrated do you need to be? Like, how much blood needs to be flowing in all the right places? Because we all know growers and not showers sometimes. Some people are just showers, you know. It can really go either way.
And if you fluff too much, then it's obvious that you did something.
Yeah. I felt like I was always sort of like, as far as my stage experience was concerned, I was like lucky. And I always felt lucky because I've been very nervous in other circumstances. And, you know, the nerves.
Nerves are will
not
do
our,
things.
It's not our friend.
Yes. Right. No, not at all.
Your dick shriveled like you got whipped.
Yeah. Exactly. Exactly. I think it was like, I'm going to misquote completely, but I remember reading somewhere about like Marlon Brando doing Last Tango in Paris and him having like one day, he was like, he described his penis as being a cashew.
Yeah.
Cashew. Oh, God,
he was
really?
So humiliated by how small
sort of,
it was.
Like, curved and tiny.
Oh, wow. Man. I don't want to think that.
Yeah, he was very embarrassed, I think, right?
Not Marlon Brando.
Sometimes it can be very uncooperative.
How could I speak of the dead that way? It's terrible.
What are you doing?
Why are you touching his hat?
He took my hat.
I know what it is.
Yeah. I thought he'd die.
I was wondering about that. What?
Why did you just take his
hat? Touch someone's hat?
It's the guest's hat.
What were you doing?
Do you want to try it on?
Don't touch it.
Trust me.
You might
want to
throw
that. They don't want you to touch anything.
You might want to throw that hat away after the interview.
Oh, my goodness gracious.
Where have you come from, Lady Di?
I come from Elizabeth, New Jersey.
Oh, okay. Oh, I've been in Elizabeth, New Jersey.
Mm-hmm.
I shot
really?
Something. Yeah, the very first first job was shot in Elizabeth, New
really?
Jersey.
Really? Look at the coincidence.
Isn't that nice?
When that happens. Wow.
Actually, I come from Brooklyn, New York.
Okay, originally.
But then my parents moved us, the family, to Elizabeth, New Jersey when I was 2 years old.
When you were 2 years old. Okay, well, my place is in Brooklyn.
Yeah.
Oh, there you go.
Okay.
In Red Hook.
Nice place in Red Hook.
Okay.
The address is...
What's the address?
No. Yeah, I don't think so, Lady
Di. Any questions for, you know, about Game of Thrones or his character? You know.
Huh?
Any questions about the show?
Yeah, what's the show about? I don't know.
What's Game of Thrones about?
You know what? It's a hard show to follow. I've seen every one.
I can't
tell you like exactly what it's about.
That's the question.
What time
that is
it?
And then the sun goes down, and we're like talking about the land, the north, and how the north has fallen.
It's such a huge cast and different like sections and different storylines going on. She just goes, what's it about? Like, you could describe it like a monkey's episode. Well,
what would you guys say?
Torque.
What would you guys say if somebody asked you, what is Game of Thrones about?
I don't know. I've seen every one, and I don't. I mean, there's Winterfell, and then there's the whole wall.
Right.
And the king got killed, and Joffrey's a bit of a twat.
It's these different kingdoms.
9 p.m. on Sunday night.
9 p.m. on Sunday night. All right.
That Joffrey.
Okay. Ugh. I love him. He's getting a little older.
9 p.m., April 6th at Marion's.
Could you call Marion to see if you could watch Game of Thrones at her house on HBO?
Are you and Marion on good terms?
Yeah, we're on good terms.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah. Yeah, want to watch Game of Thrones.
Call her up. You got her phone number.
Pedro, she's usually not here, so we apologize. And we certainly will have you back.
If
you will come back.
Because it's...
I'd be delighted to come back.
It's St. Patrick's Day, so we're... Boy, am I embarrassed.
Corned beef and cabbage day.
Beef and cabbage day is Tuesday.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And potatoes.
You want to guess her drink of choice, Pedro?
I would like to guess your drink of choice.
It is a beer.
Oh, it's a beer?
Yeah.
I'll help you out there.
It's a Budweiser?
Oh, no, that would be...
That's like high class. You got to go lower than that.
It's a Budweiser product.
Is it really?
Budweiser product?
Yeah, it is.
Did you know that?
I didn't know that.
Yeah.
That's your second clue.
It's an Anheuser-Busch product.
You said that already.
Yeah.
You said that.
And she has about 20 of these a day.
20 of them a day?
Is that right, Lady Di?
What?
20? 20 a day?
I don't know. It depends on the day.
Right. Well, which one is it?
He doesn't have time for this.
I'm
basically
promoting
what he's saying.
A major show.
What's your favorite?
I don't know. I have no idea how many a day.
No.
No.
What beer is it? What's your favorite beer?
Natural Ice.
Natty Ice.
Huh?
I don't even know what that is.
You shouldn't. It's the worst type of grog.
It's not. It's good beer.
I'll try to find one today.
Yeah.
It's a good beer.
Yeah,
I'm used to it.
Yeah.
I'm used to it. That's what you want to hear when you're talking about something you're drinking.
What a great commercial for a product.
Yeah, that would be a good commercial.
Hey, drink this. I got used to it.
You know.
When I go out, I usually drink Bud.
Oh, yeah?
Because so I was
they
right.
They don't have natural
right.
ice.
So basically, I was right.
They don't
right.
have natural ice right. at the bars.
Okay, all right.
Huh? Do they have
it? We gotcha.
What? At the bar? No.
Oh, my God.
They don't have natural ice at the bars.
We got it.
Are you done shooting, or do you have to shoot more stuff?
I'm finished with the fourth season.
Okay.
Yeah. Wow, man.
Oh, are you coming back for the fifth season?
I don't know.
I love it.
Oh, man. We could have got a spoiler
all
there.
These, you know what? For how many actors we have talked to from shows that, you know, you don't want to spoil.
Right.
They're very good with not spoiling it.
Do you know what it is? Fear.
Yeah.
We try to trip you guys up all the time.
Scary. Like,
all of a sudden it's like
fear of network corporations.
Fuck. Yeah. God damn it.
And you will never work again.
Yeah.
You don't want to be the one to blow Game of Thrones.
It's probably
not Game of Thrones.
Exactly. Probably like The Wire, when all of a sudden you find out, oh man, this is my week, and everyone gets so bummed out that, you know, that actor's leaving.
Yeah.
I wonder if there's stuff that they have shot that they don't tell people about. Like, are there certain spoilers that get shot that only a small part of the crew knows about, or that the other actors don't know about with any show?
I would assume, right?
I wonder. It wasn't like that with Game of Thrones.
No, that's probably just...
Everybody saw every script.
Because you're also shooting off in Europe, and we're talking about, like, really kind of badass Irish crews and crew in Croatia, and they don't give a shit.
Yeah, huh?
Really?
Right?
They're like, what are you fucking talking about? I don't care.
Who cares?
Here, do you want
get
a tea?
Me a fucking wow. drink.
Yeah,
exactly. Get me a Nazi ice.
Yeah. Just do your job and shut up.
Cunt.
Yeah, exactly.
How good
eat your food and do your job.
What's her real name? Amelia
Clark.
Yeah, how good does she look in person? She's fantastic.
She looks amazing in person. Right? Yeah.
She looks amazing.
She looks really, really good in person. She has dark hair. Lena Headey, on camera and in person, gorgeous. But she's got the dark, she's got the big blonde wig. They both have, like, the blonde wigs. And in person, they've got these, like, Lena particularly is, like, kind of shaggy, you know, punk, dark hair. She's, like, stunning. And I think she kind of gets away with being she gets to be a little bit more anonymous than the other people because she looks so different.
So different, like, than a character,
in real life.
Yeah, she's fucking fantastic.
Yeah, she's good, right?
Yeah.
They're all so good.
They're all good.
There's no ugly girls on that show at all.
No.
Which one are we supposed to be talking to? The other one who's playing, she's marrying Joffrey. I don't know what her
name is. Natalie. Dormer. Yeah,
I don't remember her name, but she's
sure.
really sexy.
Yeah, she's coming in.
Yeah.
She's going to be coming in?
Yeah. I hope so, yeah, right?
Yeah. Awesome.
Yeah, we get all the big stars, Pedro. My
I want to sleep with every girl on Game of Thrones.
Even little Maisie, you sicky. Hey.
Something happened over there.
What happened, lady?
My coffee.
All right, you have one final question because Pedro's got to go.
Why'd you take the cap off of your coffee?
Because
what happened?
I don't like drinking it with the cap on.
But you've been drinking it the whole time with the cap on. Why'd you take it off now? I'm just curious.
I don't like the cap.
Did you pour something in there?
Pedro knows all the tricks.
Right.
All of a sudden, the cap's off.
We think she spikes her stuff.
No, I don't spike anything.
One final question. Okay. Pedro really has to go. He's got a lot of press today, Lady Di. The final question is to you.
All right. You said...
Testimony.
What's the name of the show again?
Oh, my God.
What's the name of the show?
Game of Thrones.
Game of Thrones is on Sunday night at 9 o'clock.
Right.
Yeah. Not this Sunday, April 6th.
Right. April 6th.
Got a couple weeks.
It's a good question.
Is that your question?
Yeah. I don't know. Are you going to do any more shows on, like, a regular television? or basic cable or something? I don't
basic
know.
Basic cable.
So she could see you.
I am, actually. I mean, do you watch the show The Mentalist?
Oh, yeah.
I don't. You know what? Let me tell you something.
You know what, Lady Di?
Most of the time, I watch repeats.
Repeats. Well, there will be repeats of everything I do.
Right. Well, that's usually I watch... antenna TV, or maybe even a TV Land or something like that.
So you watch the Brady Bunch,
the Monkees.
Yeah, I watch the Brady Bunch.
Yeah, the Love Boat.
Not Love Boat. No,
I gotta say though, if you like the Monkees, you'll love Game of Thrones.
Oh yeah.
Yes.
Oh,
that's very similar.
That's good.
Yes.
Okay.
Can I say something, Lady Di?
Yeah.
Me too.
Okay.
Me too. I love that shit.
Yeah.
All right.
All right.
Game of Thrones is like a lot of wacky musical things.
You know, right, right.
It's very theatrical.
They just had a 3-day convention.
Who did they nominate?
The monkeys? I'm kind of surprised that one of them is not up here.
Okay.
It's still early in the week. We got to get Pedro out.
He plays Prince, how do you say your name? Oberyn Martell?
Oberyn Martell. Yes. The Red Viper. Hello, the Red Viper.
Red Viper.
Oh, didn't say that. And we expected Lady Di to throw that in, but she refused.
Right.
And it's April 6th at 9 o'clock. And tremendous job on the opening episode.
Thanks, guys. Really so glad you watched it.
Right. Congrats on the gig, man.
Thanks,
fantastic.
Man. Thanks a lot.
Really cool.
It's very violent, the first one. Some good violence and some good fucking. Every Game of Thrones has
I do love
Game of Thrones violence. It's fantastic.
You get a lot of it.
Graphic and nasty.
And you're great. Take your clothes off. Oh, he's a naughty boy.
Naughty. Pedro, come back and see us, all right?
I would love to.
It's Pedro Pascal, nice, everyone. Nice. Denny, take us to break.
Hey, how about a nice round of applause? Pedro Pascal stopping down here to Denny O's today. Make sure you sign the Wall of Fame on the way out. Good to have him here. Don't forget, Game of Thrones, April 6th. I believe it's on HBO, okay?
A long time ago, way back in history, when all there was to drink was nothing but cups of tea. Along came a man by the name of Charlie Mott, and he invented a wonder with him to be made in a pot. And we want to be an admiral and a soldier or a king. And to his praises we shall always sing. And if it is done for us, we fill the trumpet cheer. Along this Charlie Mott, the man who invented beer.
Okay, by the way, we got the shuttle buses coming down. They're going to be leaving in a little while for the parade. Make sure you have your ticket and your wrist bracelet. If you don't have that on, you're not going to be able to get on the shuttle bus to go to the
Denny
parade.
Denny.
Yeah.
What are you talking about, shuttle buses?
Got the shuttle buses coming down.
Where?
The Opie and Anthony shuttle buses. The big. Yeah. We got them with the big Opie and Anthony wrap. Yeah,
I'm
we got
that. I'm okay.
Guys in the truck. We got. Okay, we're back.
We're back.
And these guys are going to be appearing in Boston tonight, but via satellite up there on the Denny-O Vision. How about the Dropkick Murphys?
Denny-O Vision.
Yeah.
Watling Street, a gentle Irishman, mighty.
All right, Denny, thank you.
Why do the Irish always sing about being Irish? We got it. Fucking enough already.
I only like to do this because we're Irish.
Yes, we're Irish. We're all the Rovers. We like to do this because we're from Belfast.
Belfast.
Fucking heard you.
Nice. Lady Di in studio. Yes, Lady Di.
I forgot to get my hat. I'll be right back.
What for?
My hat.
Hope Smith and Wesson makes it.
Where is your hat?
Not going without my hat.
Go get your hat.
Exactly. Go ahead, Lois. Go get your lucky hat.
She's leaving the studio.
Could someone...
Look at her ass, that comb.
I know,
that
Where's her hat?
Is horrible.
With ass to match.
Yeah. Hey, Warren Haynes. Oh. Don't forget your bracelet. You can't get on the bus.
Oh, right, everybody. Don't forget.
All right. E-Rock found her hat.
Right. Fucking Christ, we know.
Lady died during that.
Love it.
Pedro Pascal interview was terrific.
Yeah. He was great, man.
I liked him a lot. He was cool. He knew how to hang.
Especially with Lady Di asking inane questions of him.
Yeah, he didn't mind.
What's the name of the show? I don't know the name of the show.
We heard you. We know. We speak English.
Lady Di, you're supposed to be our intern, not our in-studio guest for the whole show.
Yeah.
She wasn't even invited to stick around for the interview.
She just sat there.
Sat in studio the whole time.
Well, she sat because she's exhausted.
Smile. Let me see your love.
She's exhausted.
Oh, that's a good one. Wow. That isn't
how cute.
That was sort of a Laurel and Hardy look there.
You got tears coming out of your eyes. You're exhausted.
I'm exhausted, but I don't have tears coming out of my eyes.
Someone said you're gagging.
No, you do.
We want Dr. Steve on the phone to make sure you're okay. And here he is, Dr. Steve. Hey.
Hello, fellers.
So, Lady Di, it's her first day of interning for the show. She's going to intern all week if she makes it.
And her first day of partial sobriety.
Yeah, she's... let me describe what's going on here. Her eyes are watering a lot. She's coughing, and she's breathing heavy.
Out of breath.
That's from smoking.
Well, yeah.
The breathing heavy.
Okay.
exhaustion.
So she's breathing heavy.
Yeah.
And you're sweating a bit.
I'm not sweating.
I see some wet over at the ear.
Oh, that's tears.
And there were complaints of BO. Uh-huh. That's where the O and BO comes from.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
A lot of wetness around her eyes, Dr. Steve.
And a lot of this, a lot of, oh, God.
Right.
Oh, a lot of sighing. And,
right.
Oh,
okay. That's the audience.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, let's talk a little bit about alcohol withdrawal.
Well, hold on. Just so you have all the facts, she did wake up at 2, I think, and had 2 Natty Ices.
Right.
And we're not sure if she's been sipping during her internship.
No,
today.
No.
So it's been 8 hours.
I don't do that.
Yeah, about 8 hours.
Eight hours.
Here's the thing. Alcohol withdrawal symptoms usually will occur within 8 hours of the last drink.
Hey.
Mm-hmm.
And they can, but it can be delayed by days. But, you know, 8 hours is a pretty typical time. They'll usually peak in 24 hours, but of course, she won't make it that long.
Now, is alcohol withdrawal different than a hangover?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Oh, boy.
See?
Okay.
Well, so
a hangover
hear.
Is just sort of toxic effects from drinking, and then when the alcohol comes out of your system.
Uh-huh.
Just feel like shit. But alcohol withdrawal is actually a syndrome that's caused by someone who drinks every day, every day, every day, and then suddenly stops.
Uh-huh.
So the hallmark symptoms are anxiety, fatigue.
They have medication for stuff like that.
They do.
Yes.
Yeah.
It's called 12-step programs.
Oh, yeah, that, but they also have medication for...
Right. Anxiety.
I would say she has a little anxiety.
Right. Fatigue. Yep. She's showing fatigue.
She definitely has the fatigue.
What else, sir?
Irritability.
Yes. Irritability.
I'm not irritable.
Yeah, you've been a little cunty.
No, I'm
You've been
not.
A little bossy.
Uh-huh.
Clammy skin.
Oh, yeah.
Very clammy.
Extremely.
Look at her eyes and see if her pupils are enlarged.
Sam? Well, along with the rest of her.
Yeah, pupils are a little big.
Yeah, big pupils.
Wow, it's bright in here, too. That makes
No, it's not.
Yeah.
Yeah, sweating. Pallor, meaning, you know, like white. It's kind of white.
With your friends.
Yeah,
Dr. Steve.
Yes, ma'am.
I know all the symptoms of withdrawal. I already know what the symptoms are.
Okay, well, you do the...
Okay. I went through it before.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, of course I did.
And how was that for you?
The first day was rough.
Yeah.
And then after a few days, it was getting better and better.
And then what made you go back on the sauce?
What made me go back on the sauce was I was discharged from the rehab.
You were what?
All right. Wait a minute. Hold on.
Oh, man.
I was discharged from the rehab.
Right.
And I went
not
back
to be
to
confused
drinking.
With the discharge from your vagina.
Right.
Right.
That's
yeah,
a different
right,
discharge.
That's a different okay. discharge. So, yeah.
Right.
So what did you do to be discharged from the rehab early?
No. I did all 30 days.
Oh.
So congratulations. That's nice.
Yeah, it worked. Did a good job.
And how long ago was this? How long ago was
God.
This lady die?
Oh, my goodness.
February.
I
it's March.
Wait a minute. I think it was in 2007.
2007?
Yeah.
So don't you think
I think that I think that what it was.
Do you think you should give it another shot?
Part of the Malaysian...
I don't know.
Aren't you tired of being a slovenly, drunken disaster?
No, Jimmy, I actually...
Oh, sorry.
I thought you were talking
No,
to
no,
me.
No, I meant... Boy, I'm between two of them, aren't I? Like a fucking drunken Oreo cookie.
Now, the alcohol that she's drinking is having more effects than just this brief withdrawal syndrome.
Excuse me.
You guys want to do a test
Wait, hold on. What happened?
The hat started falling off her face.
Yeah.
So off her head, she went to catch it when it was right in front of her face, and she just smashed the hat into her face.
Who's this?
You.
I don't know. Who on the phone? Exactly. Who cares?
Private number.
I hope it's Kevorkian.
Oh, God. So, all right.
Sorry, Dr. Steve.
Dr. Steve, continue. I'm sorry.
Off your lummox.
Well, you know, chronic alcohol use can affect a lot of organs in the body, and one of those is the liver, but the other one is the brain.
Oh.
It can cause a thing called Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome.
What?
Wernicke-Korsakoff.
What's that?
And, we could do a couple of tests right now in the studio if you're interested.
Oh, really? Yeah.
All right.
You guys observe, and I can just tell you what to do. So the first thing that we should do is a thing called a Romberg's test. And
okay.
What this does is it tests for ataxia. And the easiest way to do it is, and someone needs to stand close to her, get her in the middle of the little vestibule.
Yeah.
And someone stand close to her in case she falls.
Now, come on, Anthony.
Hold on.
No.
Now, how do we test for
stand
a taxi?
Stand close to me.
Just stand outside, put your arm out.
A taxi.
Yeah. Lady Di, put your arms out at your side. Like your...
Opie made me do that before.
Oh, we did?
Yeah.
What? I don't remember this. Huh? Stand
arms
up.
Arms out.
No, that was just to see if you were shaking.
Turn your phone off, stand up. Disaster.
Stand up.
Turn the ringer off.
No, you need to be standing.
And yeah, yeah.
Stand up, Lady Di.
Wait a minute.
Stand up.
All right.
Stand up.
There you go.
Stand up. Okay.
Sam's going to go over there next to you to make sure you don't fall over.
I'm not going to fall over.
Exactly. No, well, you might.
No.
Exactly.
All right. Now, move the mic so we can still listen to her.
All right. Yeah, get the mic up there, buddy.
Go ahead, Dr. Steve. Sorry.
Okay. Now, she needs to put her hands out, at 90 degrees.
Out to your sides.
Out to your side, yes.
No, straight out like a cross. Yeah. Make a cross
like,
of yourself.
Like you're a fucking flying dinosaur.
Right.
Now, she needs to look up at the ceiling and continue to look at the ceiling.
Look at the ceiling.
Yeah.
Now, close your eyes.
Close your eyes.
And hold that for 30 seconds.
30 seconds. Go.
No,
you
got to
look up still.
Look up. Close your eyes. All right, 30 seconds.
Okay.
30 seconds starts right now.
Look straight up with your head.
Now stay right there, Di.
Stay right there. Close your eyes.
My eyes are closed.
Why aren't you looking up?
She stopped already. What are you doing?
No.
She's taking the headphones off.
All right. She's going to try again.
Okay. So arms out.
All the way up. Your head all the way up. Look at the ceiling first before you close your eyes. Open your eyes.
Look at the ceiling.
Now close your eyes.
Now close your eyes and keep your head up like that.
All right, 30 seconds
to
start.
Stay there.
Don't move.
Okay.
Don't move.
Stay there.
All right, she's wobbling.
She's okay.
She's wobbling.
She's wobbling.
Teeny bit.
A little bit so far. Keep looking.
Straight up, your head.
Don't open your eyes.
Her hands are not shaking. Her arms are pretty straight. She's not moving any worse than I would be if I was tired.
Like an airplane.
Okay, yeah.
I'm sure you went as much as you want to.
Laying back and forth. I wish I knew which positive.
What's that, Steve?
I said small adjustments are okay, but swaying back and forth.
I would say there's some swaying.
Yeah, maybe
there's a little sway.
There was some sway, but I don't think she was really doing it proper.
Yeah, she didn't hail a taxi.
She's not totally looking straight up at the ceiling, and it looks like her eyes were fluttering.
Right.
Sit up.
And. If you have Kenny do a finger-to-nose sobriety test, where she takes her arm, or we can just do it, and she takes her arm and puts it out at the side at 90 degrees, and then...
Stand back up.
No. Yeah, stand up. You got to do another test.
Why are you saying no?
Why not?
One more test.
You got to do another test.
One more test. This is part of your internship.
One more test.
Fucking phone.
Enough with the phone!
Why are you fooling?
Holy shit!
Somebody's calling me!
All right, but we're on the radio! We all get calls while we're on the radio.
Holy shit.
You gotta ignore it.
Fucking ring her off.
Oh my god.
Now stand up.
Now? Okay.
Now stand up.
Okay.
Right. Now put your arms out to your sides again.
Right arm all the way out to the side.
Right arm all the way out to the side.
Close your eyes.
Close your eyes.
Yes, exactly.
Now,
close your eyes!
Bring her arm around in front of her and touch her finger to her nose.
Now touch your finger to your nose. Yeah,
if she does it easily, then that's a test that her cerebellum is working. Okay.
Now put your finger
right.
It was no problem.
All right.
Her cerebellum is working.
The problem is her gut.
Yeah.
All right. Yeah. Now the liver.
Now once I sit down, I'm not getting up for a while.
Oh, the liver.
Yeah.
She just said she's not getting up for a while if she sits down.
Yeah, I'm tired.
I think she has an enlarged liver from the look of where it's residing. Her liver looks like that piece of meat that tipped over Fred's car in the Flintstones.
Exactly. Rocky should be punching you.
We've established that her brain so far doesn't seem to be irretrievably damaged.
Right.
Her liver's another story. We would want to do blood work to see if her liver was functioning.
Right.
Yes, with a sword.
Yeah.
But as far as the acute alcohol withdrawal, it certainly...
You would never call it that.
Acute powder. Yeah.
Okay.
It sounds like she meets all the criteria for acute alcohol withdrawal, though.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, the huff.
Is that dangerous, Dr. Steve?
Well, it can be. There is a very dangerous form of alcohol withdrawal called delirium tremens. And that's usually late. It starts around 2-3 days and can go on for a week or two and can be fatal.
Okay.
Is that the typical, like, what we all saw in movies and everything, where people are kind of shaking and...
Well, the hallucinations and seizures, and they get severely confused. And the problem with it is these people will be, you know, will have to be in the intensive care unit and have to be sedated because they just go off the deep end. And the problem is, after it's over, they don't remember anything.
Wow.
So it only affects the people around them. It doesn't affect them.
Doesn't alcohol have, like, the worst withdrawal?
Yes, it's one of the most dangerous. That and Valium withdrawal are the two that can kill you. The withdrawal from narcotics is very uncomfortable, but it's very rarely fatal.
Wow.
But alcohol withdrawal can be fatal.
Man, okay.
Amazing.
So it's recommended that if you're going to do it, you do it under a doctor's supervision. There's medicine they can give you that will ameliorate the symptoms of alcohol withdrawal.
Supervision.
Damn.
When's your birthday, Di?
April 1st.
April 1st.
April 1st is my birthday.
Jesus.
Bobo. How you doing?
What?
Look at that shirt. I bought this shirt online like everyone else.
Like everyone else? I've never seen it.
All right. Yeah. Okay.
Actually, you'd have to go on eBay for one of these.
To rock more.
Right. Yeah.
He's rocking.
He rocks back and forth,
left and right. Why?
Oh, that's a nice shirt. Really, it is.
How you doing,
about the
Bobo?
Right, good.
How you doing, Bobo?
I'm doing good. Gonna be going to go
this is hilarious.
Mine in a parade.
Look, gave him a mic with no cord. There's no cord on the mic. It's hilarious. What are you doing?
Gonna go see a friend of mine in
a parade. It's wireless.
Yeah.
No, it's so obvious. It's not a wireless.
And you got a friend.
In the parade, yeah. He's a firefighter, Brian Finley.
Oh, yeah? Oh.
Sounds Irish.
Firefighter.
Firefighter, good guy.
All right. Well.
And I gotta say hi to a friend of mine who just recovered from surgery. A friend of mine, Holly, just recovered from surgery.
What does she have, her ears cut off?
No, she had something that was a tumor that...
Good answer, literally.
Oh, good. Tumor.
After a great line, he answers literally.
Of course. Yeah, why wouldn't
it? That's what I don't understand. These people, how are they actual fans of the show? What do they hear when we broadcast?
I don't know what they're hearing.
He doesn't laugh. Starker Patty doesn't laugh.
No.
I'll be right back. I gotta get my pocketbook.
What's in it? Tampa?
I have to give a shout out to two people.
She
all week.
Forgot
die,
about
die.
It.
Die. You're here all week.
Yeah, but they told me.
All right, go get your pocketbook. Dr. Steve, I think
she's. Anheuser and Bush.
I think she's really good at sneaking a drink. She's always has an excuse.
Yeah. I'm not sneaking a drink. You
let's see what's in that pocketbook.
All right.
Can we go through your pocketbook? That would be. All right, bring it in.
Bring your person book in.
Hurry up.
But get
please,
your hat
no,
on, die. If,
wait a minute. No, the hat. No, I don't need the hat.
You
right
look
now.
Cute in the hat. You look adorable.
You look cute in the hat.
Oh, boy.
You look green monster. You look like a monster in an episode of Doctor Who.
All right. Yeah. Oh, your fucking mic's not
no
on.
Mic.
How long is it going to take for you to figure
Jesus
that out?
Jesus Christ.
She's going to get her pocketbook.
This is just
we'll go through bizarre. Her pocketbook and we'll end this show. Thank you, Dr. Steve. Yeah. Everything else good?
Oh, yeah, everything's good. I'm sure the ending the show on Di's pocketbook will be as disappointing as
as the rest of the show.
I bet you're right.
Alcohol poisoning.
All right, boys. Weird Medicine, 10 p.m. Saturday on XM 103.
Bravo.
Very cool.
And thanks, Dr. Steve.
Bye.
Okay, thanks.
See you, Steve. Good job.
Killing it for Riotcast, Dr. Steve. Fred from Brooklyn sending some baseball cards.
What's he doing there?
They're Mets cards.
Yeah. Ooh.
From 1962.
When
the Mets... Man, these are pretty neat. The original
Target of the mic.
What?
That's a pretty neat card. That's the original Mets team, the very beginning.
Right. You would like these.
Yep, of course I would like these.
Should we just give them to him or should we have him do something? What would you do for these cards?
Maybe jump out a window. Would be
if you can go a year without calling the show, you'll get them.
A year.
What would you do for the cards?
Yeah.
I would. I would drop pants for them.
I would drop pants.
Oh.
I would drop pants for them.
All right, wait a minute.
Wait, we got to go through your pocketbook. Is that
no,
cool?
No, that's okay. You don't have to go through.
No, you yeah. said we could.
No, but we there's said we were going to.
Just dump it out.
Who's this?
Oh, wow.
Hi.
Hi.
Money?
No. Can we go through your pocketbook? You already said yes.
There's yeah. nothing.
Let Sam go through your pocketbook.
There's nothing in here, she said. She's pointing her head.
If we find anything that might be whatever, we'll...
Contraband.
Yeah.
First of all... It's the worst smelling pocketbook.
What is it? Just cigarettes?
Cigarettes and stale alcohol.
Nice.
What's the name of the store you buy your Natty Ice?
Talking to the mic.
Bayway Liquors.
Bayway Liquors.
Hey, Lady Di, would you let Bobo tongue kiss you for the Mets cards?
Oh my God.
Hey.
Where's the camera?
Take that out.
But.
Oh, come on.
Sam, what do we got so far?
Sam, what's
we
in
got
there?
A pack of cigarettes.
What kind of cigarettes, though?
Oh, you're right. Mavericks.
Maverick cigarettes.
Okay.
Oh, those we got are the good ones.
We got a collection of credit cards and business cards.
Oh,
whoa.
Boy.
Five free downloads from T-Mobile.
Nice.
Not too
congrats
shabby.
On that.
Yes. Oh, Investors Bank business card.
Okay.
Some smart financing.
Yep.
Yeah.
Laundry card.
Okay.
What are you looking for?
We're just seeing what's inside.
No, it's just a fun bit.
Ah, the checkbook.
Oh, it's a checkbook?
No. Wait. Don't.
Read I won't.
A little overdrawn.
This
a little
is,
overdrawn on that
why
one?
Is there a subtraction mark before the balance?
Yeah.
a lot of receipts in the checkbook.
Wow. I see that.
Yeah.
Is it tax purposes?
It is tax season.
Write off.
Balanced.
Okay.
And this is a...
What sure
is
zero.
Department of Social Services ID card.
Hey, there you go.
That was a long time ago.
Oh, bet it was.
A long time ago.
I like the idea of a kiss for this.
Oh, look at this.
Yeah, that is good.
My notebook. Yeah.
Notebook.
What's
yeah. All
what's,
kinds
what
of creative ideas.
Oh, really?
What's in your notebook?
Yeah. Eat, drink, sleep, repeat.
What did you write in your notebook?
A shout out to James Farley. And a shout out to Henry from Bayway Liquors. I want to give these two a shout out. That's what I wanted. That's what I was looking for.
I wish it was Chris Farley and you were on your way to meet him.
Can I see your pad?
That's no. Your makeup?
Don't do that.
Yeah, where'd you? Yeah, you don't. Oh, they don't want to plug. Believe me.
Jimmy's got tears
okay.
in his eyes.
Yeah,
right?
My right eye is like.
Oh,
Lady Di, I want to read your notebook, please.
No.
Why?
Oh. No.
Why? What's
just
in there?
No. Just in case
nothing.
She runs out.
Nothing.
A nice new pack of Mavericks.
You
gotta stop the smoke,
Lady Di.
Hold on. What?
What's in your notebook?
There's nothing important in my notebook.
But what is it?
Huh?
What
if it's not
right
important,
in there?
Let me
nothing. There's nothing in there.
But if there's nothing what important, let me just see it.
It's just numbers and stuff. There's nothing in
no,
there.
No, I won't read numbers on the
330 with LBS after.
Why she got that?
Apparently her boyfriend left something in her bag. There's an afro pick.
Why do you have an afro pick?
A dirty...
That's when I got a permanent in the summertime. And I had to cut it out.
Permanent.
I got a permanent. But I had to cut it out.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. The bed bugs.
I did it.
Oh, look how dirty this comb is.
That's horrendous.
This is the worst comb I've ever seen.
What do you comb with that? Your muffler?
What else?
Let's see.
And Boba, why are you tweeting right now?
No, I was tweeting the photo.
Oh, that's
a cassette.
Yeah, a cassette cover from Andrew Dice Clay, face down ass.
But where's the cassette
for?
That's for in case she wants to finger herself, I think. Look at that. You like that?
Where's the cassette?
I can't find the cassette. I don't know where it is.
All right.
Yeah.
This is the worst.
I think it's somewhere.
I want to read her notebook.
I found the cassette.
There's the cassette.
Remember you said you couldn't find it? We found it for you. In your pocketbook.
Throw things!
Yeah, come on, Sam.
Show respect.
Bag back in 1987.
Show respect for her
stuff. Who has a fucking cassette in their purse?
Oh, mass cards.
Yeah, mass cards. Oh, a little... Credit card.
All right.
Stop throwing her stuff.
Stop throwing her stuff, Sam.
I don't like that. Come on.
Yeah, have some I don't blame you.
What's that? Oh, is this a battery for your phone?
No, that's an old battery.
Oh.
Stop it!
It went on the floor.
My
it went on the floor.
Whoa. Yeah, she don't need it.
Got a little of that cashish over there.
Nice.
A little fucking guap. Make it rain.
No. Don't do that.
Make it rain.
Diana, get your money. Come on, everyone's grabbing your money.
Give it
You're grabbing your money.
Go get your money first.
Get your money, sweetheart. Get your money.
You What's in the side pockets? Anything?
No, just some mask cards.
Okay.
And then some more. Some junk? More makeup.
No booze?
Oh, God. Stop throwing her stuff.
Sam just keeps throwing.
You right?
What's the matter? You got up too fast?
Oh, man.
Why don't you take a seat?
What happened?
Nothing.
Sit down. What happened?
You okay?
Wait, what happened?
I don't know. She
doesn't look good.
Oh, boy.
What's the matter?
What happened?
Lady died.
I just feel a little nauseous. That's all.
Oh, boy.
Uh-oh.
I told you she's pregnant.
Morning sickness?
Yeah,
it's
morning sickness.
No!
It's morning sickness.
Congratulations once again. Lady Di is pregnant. Make sure you congratulate her on Twitter.
Stop around.
And CC Colin Quinn.
Did you eat a healthy breakfast, Di?
Thank you for the bag.
I don't ask for much, but please do that. Thanks.
You got to eat breakfast. What are you doing?
Oh.
What's going on? You feel nauseous?
You got to have a breakfast, Margie.
It's the most important meal of the day.
Yeah.
You probably stood up too quick and you didn't eat breakfast. You're drinking coffee and no breakfast.
Yeah, you're a disaster.
You okay?
Wait.
What happened?
Nothing. Yep. I got a little nauseous, okay?
All right.
My friend Stevie Knight over in England says you need to try the full English breakfast.
Now I just did.
The full English breakfast.
I'm not sure what it is. I know it's a big...
Just talking into thin air. Fucking dunderhead. Use a microphone.
Dunderhead.
I believe there's 10 microphones.
Yeah,
he could have grabbed any one of them.
He's using.
He speaks in a thin air.
No,
stop around. Putz.
You're right.
That's not nice.
Lady Di, can I read something from your notebook?
No.
Sam, could you get the notebook?
Where is the notebook?
Now my
it's under there. There it is.
Hold on. Wait a minute, your legs hurting.
I promise. Air.
Which one won't you like, Di?
I promise I won't read phone
Standing
numbers.
Up.
Oh, she smells like booze. Jesus.
Wow.
Once in a while.
I smell liquor.
Oh boy!
From where?
I don't know.
Intestines.
Hey, you do math?
No kidding.
What are all those numbers?
Nice. She does math.
Yeah.
That's balancing my. It's called balancing your checkbook.
Yeah. If there's.
Oh my God! You gotta smell this.
No.
Ciggies.
Six.
I smell
five
cigarettes and booze. Lady Di.
Oh
my God.
Oh,
there you got a cupcake.
No. I don't want.
She's right. Here, Lady Di.
I don't want anything.
Nothing in there.
Thank you.
Who's cupcake?
There's nothing in there.
Linz can spell that all the way in Boston.
Oh yeah. I don't want a cupcake, thank you.
Why is he going for cheap, plugs?
Little plugs. Yeah, why did you bring up Linz?
That had nothing to do with anything.
Yeah, what did you promise to bring?
She just told me that she could smell it all the way
Oh, boy.
My fingers smell like I've been smoking all morning now.
Yeah. Just I have a cupcake, you gotta eat something.
I'm all right.
No, we're not kidding.
Start seeing your face every time during the Mets game, every commercial break.
Huh?
What?
I don't know. You're smoking so much, I'm going to start seeing your face every commercial break now.
I don't get it.
It's the cancer cigarette.
Lady
Di.
What?
Please eat the cupcake. We're not kidding.
No.
You're nauseous.
You need some sugar in you.
Really, I'm all right.
You sure?
There's alcohol
in
it.
No, there's no alcohol in it.
There is. It's Bailey's. It's Guinness and Bailey's.
Oh,
brother.
That would be kind of perfect.
Weren't we supposed to bring those in sooner than this? We're going home now. And it's got to get across town before the parade.
Yeah.
Lady Di, how do you feel your first day went? You got four more of these.
I still have a lot to learn.
You do have a lot to learn.
Yeah, I do, really. You know, the computer thing and everything like that, it's a lot. I didn't realize how much it was.
A little more time outside of the studio, maybe?
Huh?
Maybe a little more time outside of the studio?
Maybe. Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I think we did pretty well here today.
Getting to do the phones and stuff like that, that's...
That was good.
That's kind of hard.
Very well.
We'll give you another shot at that tomorrow, all right?
All right.
Yeah.
How are you going to get here tomorrow? You getting Adrian to pick you up again?
Why won't Bill give you money?
What a piece of shit.
I don't know why he doesn't. You know, he probably will.
He is about a piece of shit, isn't he?
He's a pinch penny, right?
That fucking guy. Fuck him.
He's a fucking asshole.
You suck his dick and he doesn't even fucking give you money?
Come on, guys.
Yeah.
You said he's a pinch penny, right?
No.
Showing him those tits for free,
right?
Yeah.
I show him my tits for free.
Yeah. Yes, and I'm quick with a joke, and I smell like a smoker.
You know, Bill smokes too, you know.
Hey.
Here, Bobo, take these cards.
Oh, boy.
You don't have to show you.
There you go, Bobs.
Yeah. You know, a kiss would have been nice.
Take those.
Oh, wait. Could you kiss Bobo?
You have to.
Yeah, give Bobo just a quick makeup.
Hold on, not yet.
Oh, look at this.
Not yet.
Deep tongue.
Hold on, not yet.
What?
This is going to be the big St. Patty's Day tongue kiss.
Right.
Kiss where?
On the mouth.
Hold on a minute. Hold on.
Okay.
Hold on.
Go. Oh, wow. Look at this.
Open mouth.
Open mouth.
No, come on.
Come on.
No,
it's just that.
Tongues. For the show.
And for these
cards. Come on, it'd be fun.
You know, they already think that I'm pregnant. You know that.
Go for it, lady die.
I know that.
Do it. Go for it.
Denny.
I know that.
Wait.
What? What happened?
All right, ready? What's the matter?
Do I have to do this?
Oh, it's just a kiss for Pete's
Wait, you're
sake.
Saying that? Wait, she said that?
Yeah.
Oh.
What's the matter?
Believe me.
Turn your hat back.
All right, here we go.
Give him a mouth kiss.
Ah! Oh, yeah. What happened?
The fucking kiss in The Shining was sexier.
Holy shit.
How'd that go, Bobo?
In The Shining. How'd you like it, Bubs?
I'm gonna
eat a few mints after this.
Don't say it. Don't say
All right, listen.
Don't say what?
Jimmy, you got a plug before
Yeah, Virginia Beach this weekend, Thursday, Friday, Saturday.
Okay.
Funny
okay.
ball.
All right, I guess we did it. Danny, you got to do all the thank yous and get us out of here. All the thank yous. Don't forget about Pedro Pascal from Game of Thrones.
Yes.
No.
Lady Di and Dr. Steve and Colin Quinn and Bobo, unfortunately, and whatever else you can think of. Cupcakes, all right?
Is Colin Quinn going to be in the show anytime?
Oh, my God. Take us out there, Danny.
Shit.
Oh, that's out. We're okay, guys in the truck just gave me the cue. Once again, thank you so much for coming down today to Denny O's. How about a nice round of applause for everybody on the show today? Anthony Okumia, Opio Opie, Jimmy O. Norton, Sam O. Roberts, the whole gang. E-Rock. Thank you, E-Rock, for those great cupcakes today. Everybody, Bobo came down. Lady Di will be back with us. Pascal Perez was here today. All right, we had a great time.
Dennis.
Yes.
Diane O'Banny.
Diane O'Banny. All right, Diane, writing her own material there. You guys have a safe one. Once again, the buses will be leaving pretty soon.
Yeah.
So if you have your bracelet and your ticket, get on the shuttle bus to go to the parade.
Oh, man.
Have yourself a great St. Patrick's Day.
Might have been the gym. Could have been the 3 or 4 6 packs, I don't know. But look at the mess I'm in. My head's like a football. I think I'm gonna die. Tell me, oh, me, oh, my. Wasn't that a party? Someone took a grapefruit, wore it like a hat. I saw someone under my kitchen table talking to my old tomcat. They were talking about a hockey. The cat was talking back. Along about then, everything went black. I wasn't that hardy. I'm sure it's just my memory playing tricks on me. But I think I saw my buddy cutting down my neighbor's street. Could have been the whiskey. Could have been the 3 or 4 6 packs, I don't know. But look at the mess I'm in. My head's like a football. I think I'm gonna die. Tell me, oh, me, oh, my. Wasn't that a party?
The Opie and Anthony Show has drawn to a close. Stay tuned to reflect, relive, and get the story behind the story of the finest moments of today's show. Sam Roberts, Opie and Anthony post-show begins in moments.